Welcome to the Weekend Live Show.
508 is where I'm from.
We run down the biggest stories of the week with you every Saturday night. Let us know in the comments right now where you reppin'.
Patchy Junction, Taunton, Worcester, Long Island, Manchog, Winkler, Florida, Webster, Malden, Framingham, Tucson, Arica, Salem, Gloucester, Moose Up, Connecticut, Charleston, South Carolina, Roslindale,
Moose Up, Connecticut, London,
Hanson, Glendale, Arizona, Lynn, Mapleville, Quincy,
Food stamps, leave your clothes, buddy, and
thank them with you. You funny ass guy, man.
Have you ever heard a term like, yeah? Are you a fan?
508 is where I'm from. 508
is
where I'm from.
What the hell was that?
Oh, it's fucking Giannetti.
You freaking idiot. Stop telling people that I'm mentally deranged and stupid.
It's homosexuals that love them.
Nobody wants to see your dick pics, dude. Oh, can't show it. It's a Giannetti dick pic.
NFL on the house, plug that.
Let's get this party started.
Yo, what's up, turtle people? How's everyone doing out there tonight? Good? Good, excellent. Welcome to the live show, ladies and gentlemen. I am your fearless host. They call me Uncle Turtle Boy around here. My real name's Aiden. You can call me Clarence, or I really prefer Doctor. A lot of people are calling me Doctor these days, because if Jill Biden's a doctor, then I'm definitely a doctor. So it's also my Twitter handle. So follow me on Twitter at Dr. Turtle Boy. That's D-O-C-T-O-R Turtle Boy. You can follow me on Facebook at Clarence Woods Emerson. That's my personal account. But you can just hit the follow button. It's a lot of action on the Clarence Woods Emerson page. It's like almost, I think, 38,000 followers on there now. So it's kind of fun. We also have a regular page called Turtle Boy. If you're new here, you haven't seen the struggle with Facebook. We used to have a page like 112,000 people in 2017. That was taken down. We've had the rebuild like a million times. We've had like 50 pages. They all get taken down. They've let us stay up for a while. I really don't care if they take it down or not. We're just going to build new ones. It's just what we do around here. We don't rebuild. We reload. We just keep going in the face of unprecedented censorship. I was like banned from Twitter for a million years or two, like two and a half. But then I got back on because I got to get a new computer. It's a long story, but I got back on there because they were tracking my IP address. And I've been on there. I think I'm up to like 42,000 followers on there. And we just passed the 40,000 subscriber mark here on YouTube. So that's pretty cool. Even though I don't really like this platform because they're always kicking us off. If you're new here, make sure you smash that subscribe button, and you're going to want to hit that notification bell because there's going to be some impromptu lives happening, because we do this show every Tuesday and Saturday night at 9 p.m. But we also do a lot of impromptu lives. Like, you know, if I'm going somewhere on a road trip to somewhere, you know, south of Boston, that area, and I don't want to give them ahead of time a little heads up, I might do a little impromptu. So you're going to want to hit that notification bell because it'll tell you when we're live, so you can tune in and see what the hell's going on, because you're gonna want to know, because a lot of good stuff going on in the upcoming weeks that I anticipate. So we're also on Rumble. YouTube kicks us off a lot. That's the thing. Like, they've taken down like 10% of our shows. This is show, I think, 605 or 604. I forget. And probably at least 60 shows have been taken down. So they're very censorious. So there is an alternative to YouTube that I would encourage you guys to subscribe to if you haven't already. I see 110 people over there on it right now. It's called Rumble. I'm going to put it in the chat right there. Boom. Rumble is like a free speech alternative to YouTube. They don't take down anything. All of our stuff is on there. We've never had anything taken down on Rumble. It's kind of cool. Like, the way the internet was supposed to be. You're supposed to say what you want, and if other people don't like it, they just go on their merry way. Somewhere along the line, we got it confused that if somebody says something you don't like, you just report it and get them kicked off the internet. That seems to be the new thing. YouTube still, I'm noticing less and less of that. The bigger we get here, Turtle Boy, the harder it is to do for us. Like, I was on Court TV, obviously, this week, and we're going to see, like, they tried, man, to keep me off Court TV. They tried. It's just not having the same effect that it used to. Like, the whole deep, I've outgrown them. You can't do that to me anymore. So go to Rumble anyway, because you never know which one, like, if we're going to get kicked off here, you might get shows taken down. We have no control over any of that. So just go over there, create an account if you haven't done so already. We got a bunch of people. How many people we got? We got 134 over there watching right now. So, okay, the Rumble rats, as they call them over there. Anyway, we're also on all sorts of, various like look in the bio or on Spotify. A lot of you guys obviously watch this live. We got 1500 on YouTube right now. We got another 150 on Rumble that'll grow throughout the program. But a lot of people, like probably like only 10% of people watch it live. Most people just watch it on the replay the next day while they're going about their business or doing whatever. So you could, you know, check it out on Spotify, whatever you want. I like it better on YouTube and on Rumble because there's a lot of visuals you need to see. There's a lot of visuals you need to see in this documents that we go over, videos. And it's just not the same. It's just not the same, but to each their own, to each their own. Okay. Here's the deal, guys. If you like the program and you would like to support us and you'd like to donate monetarily, you can't do it with the old way that you do on YouTube. A lot of YouTube channels have this thing called Super Chat where you can click the dollar sign button and boom, you can give money to whatever streamer that you want to do. Well, you can't do that with us because we had the wrong opinion about 2 years ago. It's like August 2021 about a certain president's vaccine mandate. Wasn't a fan and I had some harsh words for it. And it was like a big no-no. So they said, you can't give this guy money anymore. He's bad news. Like your money, you might want to give him money. You might think he deserves it. You might consider yourself a grown adult and him a grown adult. And like, that's how grownups work. But actually YouTube is your daddy. Google's your daddy and they know better than you. They're doctors. And so they said, you can't do it. You can't give that man, he's bad money. You can't give the bad man money. So we can't do it anymore, which is fine because those crooks took like 30, 40% anyway. So what we did is we built our own platform because that's what you have to do. I'm banned from PayPal. I'm banned from like everything. You just build new things. So we built our own thing. It's called Turtle Chat. If you click at the link at the top, that basically brings you to a place where it's like our own little super chat. You can donate whatever amount of money you want and you get to write a little message. I will get that message in my email and I will periodically throughout this program read them out loud to the class. You can also Cash App me if you're into that because I can't do it to PayPal at $UncleTurtleBoy. I will get that notification on my phone and I will read your messages out loud to the class as you send them. I got a couple already. Let me start by reading a couple. We got one from Jeff starting us off right. He's got no comment with this turtle chat, but he sends $100. So thank you very much, Jeff. I graciously appreciate that, sir. And let me tell you, like we're investing in this shit, man. Like things are about to get big around here. I'm telling you. We are, I want to start hiring people full time specifically. Like we need to do more. Like people love the getting up in your faces stuff. People love when I go up there with a microphone. Like I want to do it where I'm not the one holding the camera. We want to get like a nice, we got to figure this out. We got to figure it out. Like a nice freaking camera that can also stream. Like it has to be out there. We just have to research it. We got to get mics. We got to do it all. So that's what we're going to start doing more and more instead of me walking around my phone vertically like this. We don't need any of that. So we're going to be doing that. So thank you. This is, you know, basically I'm not one of those people that just, you know, goes and blows it all in the casinos. I'm not an Albert. I reinvest in my company. Like he doesn't do that. I've been in D&E Pizza. There has been zero upgrades or investments in that business since the beginning of time. So DW sends $25, says the detractors are getting antsy and loud. You are right. You are right over the correct target and the losers can't take it. Nice work as always. Yes, absolutely. So we are, and we got a couple Cash Apps already. I can read out. We got one from, let's see. Where are they? Okay. We got one from Deanna. Says $20. She says for Yannetti, call me. Yeah, he's very popular these days. He's very popular. And yeah, Jason sent $20 the other day. Says Duncan for Duncan's Run. Great job, Mr. Mayor. That's right. I am the mayor of Canton. So get that right. So if anyone else would like to donate, link is at the top. The thing is in the bio. You know, the Cash App is $ Uncle Turtle Boy. And yeah, that's how we do it. So let's just jump right into it, shall we? Where shall we start this afternoon or this evening rather? Man, I'll just start off with this. I think I have some thoughts about Canton. Okay, let me say this first. I think something big is going down. That's just my personal opinion. Something's in the air, man. Like I said, I've heard from a couple people over the past couple weeks that Brian Higgins has flipped. Reliable people are starting to say that. And the beauty of, you know, a certain other bootleg YouTuber who is obsessed with yours truly, who has kind of become the de facto spokesperson for the bad guys, said something interesting, which that about Brian Higgins flipping, like they don't trust him. Like anything she says, you can assume came from like a text message from Jill Daniels or Jen McCabe or one of those people. And it's very clear something's going on with that relationship. Like very clear. Like Brian Higgins would be stupid not to save himself. He can't. I mean, he's going to get in trouble for something, but he could get a lot more trouble. So something is going down. You couple that with the fact that Colin Albert this week voluntarily gave up football and like being a student at Bridgewater State. And like something's up with that. Like that's bigger than I think a lot of people realize, just in my opinion, because the Alberts, what I learned about Chris Albert, we're going to see tonight, is that motherfucker's stubborn. Like the fact that he sits up there at these Board of Selectmen meetings and just gets berated. Like it's like shit on Chris Albert hour. It's like the roast of Chris Albert, except it's not in good fun. Roasts are supposed to be in good fun. He just sits up there with his Dunkin' Donuts iced coffee and he just gets roasted by the townsfolk. They just come in there now. You're like, you're a piece of shit. You are yelling sexually derogatory things at women. You killed someone. That was brought up at the last meeting. You literally killed a man. Can we talk about that for a minute? You have $65,000 in liens against you, all these court judgments, and you're running a $15 million budget here. Why are you here? Why haven't you not resigned yet? He just sits up there and takes it. He just sits up there and he takes it. He doesn't respond. He doesn't say anything. He just takes it. And Chris Albert is a dumbass. There's no way that Chris Albert is sitting up there liking being on the Board of Selectmen. Like, he might like the prestige that comes with it. He gets to wear a suit for the first time in his life. But I guarantee he is, like, thinking about bullshit. Like, he's like, oh, you know, pussy. Like, he's like, oh, I like to fuck Jill Daniels up here. Like, he's thinking about some raunchy shit, that guy. And I'm not just saying. He's made comments like that before. Former employees of D&E Pizza have said that to me. So, being on the Board of Selectmen is a boring job. Like, have you ever watched your local Board of Selectmen meeting or even a city? They're boring as shit for the most part. Unless you live in Boston or someplace like that where you have a bunch of crazy people like Kendra Lara on the city council. But for the most part, it's probably going to be a really boring meeting. They talk about numbers and budgets and nobody, like, there's no way Chris Albert's having fun up there. So what I'm getting at here is that it's something in the blood in that Chris Albert clan family. Like, they're stubborn people. And the fact, like, Chris Albert would never let his son, he would never give me the victory and us the victory of letting his son give up being a student and an athlete, a football player. Like, being a football player in the Albert family is a big deal. His cousin Brendan's the captain of the team. That's Brian's middle son. Like, these guys all played Canton football. Like, Brian was the coach of the Canton football team. He would not let his son just give this all up unless something was going on. Like, that, it feels that way, man. It feels like something is happening. And I pray to God it does. I don't know. It's just a feeling. I have no insight on that whatsoever. It just, doesn't it seem to you people like that? Like something's going on. Like there's just too much momentum and it's not like, it's obviously great work by her attorneys to do this, but it's also all of us, you know, we have, without us out there on the courthouse steps, like that courthouse protest, guys, that is what caught the attention of Court TV and all these other media outlets. They're like that. They never see that. You never see a protest. Like it's like the red carpet when Karen Reed showed up there and I'm on my bullhorn and we're booing Carl Dougal. Of course the media frames it as they're booing the family. Okay. That's a lie. That's fake news. We didn't boo the family. Although we're going to end tonight. I don't think an in-law counts as a family. Erin O'Keefe. You've been very naughty. So we need to talk about what she's been doing tonight. That's one of the things we're going to be getting into, the antics of her. That's Paul O'Keefe's, you know, glug, glug, drive, drive, Paul O'Keefe her, she's the wife of Paul O'Keefe. So, nobody booed him, basically. We didn't boo any family. So it's all a lie. I just feel like because of what we're doing, and like I said, the free Karen Reed thing, a lot of people, remember when the free Karen Reed shirts were made and people were like, you should do Karen Reed is innocent instead. People were all fired up about that. Like that was a free Karen Reed is like the greatest branding thing in the history of marketing. Like it is. Like free Karen Reed is everywhere. People are writing it in the sand. People are putting it on flagpoles. Like there are freaking yard signs with QR codes everywhere now. Like this has taken on a life of its own, this story. And it's just like, they see this happening and they see that once they saw Dateline was happening, like, oh, that's not good. That's never good. That's never good. And then they see Matt Gutman at the last protest and Boston Magazine's calling these people up. And because they liked it when the Boston Globe was doing what they always do, ignoring a real story like that. And WCVB was doing what they do best, covering up a real story because they have personal ties to it through Greg Henning and Katie Thompson, that animal abusing piece of shit. So Katie Thompson, Falconer, that is. By the way, she's pregnant again. Can you believe that? She's hiding behind pregnancy again. Oh, and she did a thing on this the other day. It was disgusting. Like, it's like, I don't want to get into that. Anyway, so I just feel like there's something going on here. But maybe I'm wrong. Maybe my senses are wrong. I don't know. Again, this is just an opinion. It's not a fact. It's not based in any... It is based in something. Some things I've seen, obviously, with Colin Albert and the Brian Higgins rumors and all that. But it's just... I don't know. I just feel like something's happening. However, at the same time, it's like somebody said this to me the other day about Karen Reed. It's like, this is no way to live. Like, this is not a life. Like, how long can one person deal with this cloud? Like, I've said from the beginning that I do not want this to go to trial. Not that I fear her getting found guilty or anything like that, but just, that's a sham. Like it should never go. Like this should be dropped. If there's any justice in the world, these charges should be dropped. And the people that actually did this should be charged for it. But at the same time, like how long can this go on for? Like, and how much stress does this take on a human being? Like this has to be putting years on Karen Reed, like mentally. So for her sake, it's like, wouldn't the best thing for her be to just get this over with? Like, let's fucking dance. Let's dance. Oh, remind me to show you the Reddington text tonight too. I've never showed these before. I decided I'm going to show them tonight. Fuck it. So I just wrote it down. But like, if you were her, like, don't, like, let's go. Let's fucking do it. Like, I understand not wanting to, and this has been my position from the beginning, because I've thought about being in this position before, and just the roller coaster that must be happening in your stomach in those few hours where you're sitting there waiting for a jury verdict to come back. Like, and you see, like when Kyle Rittenhouse was exonerated, like he fucking, like it was authentic. He broke down crying. Like it was crazy. Like it's just like so much can change in one word. And, you know, either with not just if the word not is in there, isn't in there, your whole life is over. Like, it's like, imagine that life in prison, or you go on to become a very wealthy person. And that's what she will be after this, a very wealthy person and deservedly so, book deals and got, you know, movie rights and God knows what she'll get out of this, or life in prison. Now, there's like a 99.999% chance it would be the first one, not life in prison. But would you want that? Like, would you get on a plane if you thought there was a 1% chance that plane would crash? Would you want to get on that plane? You know, wouldn't you rather just like, if like, I'll just fucking drive. But then driving is expensive and you're stuck in traffic and you're like, fuck it, I'm jumping on a plane. This isn't worth it. And that's kind of the position that I think she's in. And like, obviously it's selfish on my part and on all of our part, I think, that we would love to see a trial. Like, obviously that would be great for us. Like, it would be wild and it would be so entertaining. And we could watch Alan Jackson just freaking eviscerate. Oh, can you just, like, I got hard thinking about it, man. About thinking about what Alan Jackson and David Unetti and Liza Little will do to Michael Proctor on the stand or Jennifer McCabe. Oh, I get turned on thinking about it. I'm not going to lie. It's so exciting. But I think I also think about Karen Reed's father and her mother and her brother and what they're going through. And like what, like it's not as fun for them. And so I'm like, they would obviously much rather just see this get dropped, but like, I don't know if that's going to happen. Like, you know what I mean? So it's like, let's just fucking get in a room and fuck. Like, let's just do it. Let's just get this over with. Let's go. And whoever wins, wins. And we know who's going to win. You are not going to find 12 people that are going to believe, yeah, she fucking did that. Like, and you know how I know that, guys? Just go on any of these websites. Go on, like, there was a YouTube channel the other day. What was it? It was like, they have 1.8 million subs. Irish guy. Somebody sent it to me. A real Irish guy, not that Irish demon loser. A cool Irish guy. Does like true crime. And somebody sent it to me, and he covered it fairly, I thought. Like, he even suggested what they were saying about her. He said both sides. And like, in the comments, all you need to do is go in the comments. Like, I'm not concerned what he said. I'm concerned what the audience thought. And so I go in the comments and I read it, and it's just like, everyone's just like, no, they all have the same reaction to us. And that's who's going to be on a jury. People, like regular people, will be on a jury, not necessarily turtle riders. Maybe they will find 12 people who are hearing the story for the first time. Maybe. Remember the first time you heard the story? Like, what was your reaction? That's what you're going to get in court. And you've seen Adam Lally in action. Does he exactly strike you as a sharp litigator? Like, the deck is stacked against Adam Lally in this. In order for him to get a conviction, the mountains of things he needs to get through are insane. Does he seem like he has the personality for that? No. Lunchbox game. Like, he's going to embarrass himself. Like, it's going to be a mess. Like, he's the worst ADA in Norfolk County too. I've seen in these other cases, they actually have competent assistant district attorneys with a little flavor to them in Norfolk County. But in this case, they're throwing in Lunchbox because it's on purpose. They're like, oh, we're going to throw, just feed him to the wolves. Go ahead, Lunchbox. You got this one. You're going to do great, pal. They put a kick me on his back. So I'm like, if I'm Karen Reed, you know, at a certain point, I'm like, let's go. Let's do this. You know? And I don't know. So we'll see what happens, man. This can't go on forever. That's all I'm saying. It cannot go on forever. There has to be an ending. Now, it's like, I've thought about I don't even remember life before Canton. It's been 4 months of this. It's been a roller coaster ride. A lot of you people are here. Like, we have over 20, how many people are watching? 2,100 on YouTube. We got another 250. So we got like 2,300 people watching now. The live shows used to have 300 people watching. It's like, I can't even remember pre-Canton. And I'm like, what do we do after this is over? I don't even know. I guess we go back to talk about ratchets or whatever. We'll still do some, obviously, investigative reporting. We've been doing that before Canton, and we'll do that after, but it ain't going to be the same. I'm going to have to get used to it. It's going to be weird. Yeah, they're like, Fucci. Yeah, Fucci was the big talk. That was entertaining. Mike Fucci was very entertaining. I'll give him that. The Fuchster. But yeah. So anyway, we're gonna have a lot more fun with this. Oh, stop with Ryan his way. Oh, Sandra Birchmore. We're gonna get to that too. Like, we need to do a whole thing, revisit the Sandra Birchmore case. I need to go through. Like, I'm going to look at that case so much differently now. If you're unfamiliar with Sandra Birchmore, she was a 23-year-old girl, woman. She was a graduate of Stoughton High School, the neighboring town of Canton. And she went through this Explorers program that was run by a guy named Divine. And he was the ultimate groomer. And he was sexually inappropriate with the kids. I believe he had sex with Sandra when she was out of, like, they waited till they got out of high school. I believe. Think. No. Farwell banged her, I think, when she was 15. So he banged. She had sex with Matt Farwell, who is a Canton cop who went through the same Explorers program. And then Billy Farwell, his twin brother, who's also on there. And then there was another guy named Josh Heal, who might have been doing some stuff too. And then he got moved to Abington. And I think he's still on the payroll there. But when it first happened, it was reported as a suicide. The girl was pregnant and it was reported as a suicide. And it was like, my take on it was like, oh, these people pushed her to this. Like, he impregnated her. She was pregnant. Matt Farwell impregnated her and then abandoned her like trash. And so she was distraught and she killed herself. But now I look back on that. I'm like, why did I believe that? Because you know what town she lived in? She lived in Canton, right on the border. And the first one to find her, first officer there was Lank, the same officer who was the first one to respond to Fairview Road, who Jennifer McCabe personally called back at 8:38 a.m. and said, Mikey, I totally forgot. I have something to tell you. Can you come back over here to 34 Fairview Road so I can tell you in person? Oh, yeah. Actually, Karen Reed was actually saying that, oh, my God, could I have hit him? Could I have hit him? I broke my tail. I totally forgot to mention that. Yeah, I know it's like wicked incriminating, and it's probably like the first thing that would have come to mind, but like I just totally, you know, totally forgot. So like, can you write that down and like maybe like arrest her? Because she's like totally crazy and she's like a wicked big drunk and she's just a wicked bitch. So, and she doesn't even go here. She's not even from Canton. So we can't have people killing nice guys like John and leaving him on the front lawn like that. It's just not good for the neighborhood. You know what I mean, Mikey? Thank you. Go arrest her now. That was basically what they did. So Blank was the guy that first responded to Sandra Birchmore. And now I look at that and I'm going to go back and listen to Kirk Minahan's podcast, The Case, season 2, about this. They did a whole thing. And he interviewed a lot of friends of Sandra Birchmore who were adamant she would not kill herself. Now, Sandra Birchmore her mom was dead. Her grandmother dead. Her aunt, like everybody she loved was dead. She had nobody in life, like nobody. So that's why I thought she killed herself. Because I'm like, this woman's like got this horrible like life. But then all of her friends, like she wouldn't do that. But she doesn't have anyone in her family to advocate for her, you know, the way that Karen Reed does. And I'm just wondering, like, is that like, maybe we should have taken a deeper look at that. Like Matt Farwell is seen on video leaving her apartment. Last person to see her alive. And she allegedly killed herself. The D'Angelo Barksdale way in jail for the Wire people. She was found. Literally, like, I don't know if you guys watched The Wire. D'Angelo Barksdale, Avon's brother, went to jail for 20 years. Didn't even want to be in the game anymore, and that's where they made him go. He was going to rat on him, but then his mother made one take one for the team. And then he was going to flip in prison. And so Stringer Bell orders a hit on him, and so they kill him. They hire this guy to kill him, and then the guy takes his belt and does it to the doorknob thing, and they sits him down like this. And that's how you get, because that's how guys kill themselves in prison, is because they got no other choice. That's how they found Sandra Birchmore. Like the exact same way that D'Angelo Barksdale was found, like it was framed. So, you know. Anyway, poor D'Angelo. He didn't want to be in the game anymore. He's upset about Wallace, but okay. So we're going to take a deeper dive into that definitely when the time comes. So anyway, let's talk about a couple other things here that I want to get into. All right. First thing first, we got to talk about Helena Rafferty. Oof. And I got some phone calls to make tonight too. All right. So don't forget that. Let me read a couple turtle chats here before we do that. Semolina sends $25, says great work. Interesting that Colin withdrew from being a Bridgewater Bear. Soon he may be a bear bait in jail. Yes. Hopefully so. We also have Melvin sends $50, says the Alberts and Bidens are obviously related, crooked and stupid. Well, wasn't Hunter Biden? Isn't he finally being investigated? So maybe there is some hope. I don't know. Maybe that's a good sign too. Lisa sends $20, says Merry Christmas. Lisa from Dedham. Hi, Lee. Thank you. She sends the Christmas tree. Lisa knows the thing too about, being vilified unfairly. She was the one that wanted to keep a Christmas tree up in the Dedham library. She got vilified by these crazy, scissorsauruses. Ashley sends $5, says, I'm dying to know what Carl thinks about being called a moron in national TV. Oh, he's just a local moron. It came so naturally. I didn't know what to say. So, yeah, he's a local moron. A random fucking resident sends $20. We're going to get to that. It says, a contribution towards your new camera. Keep up the good work, doctor. Thank you. And thank you for calling me by my correct pronoun, doctor. We also got a couple cash apps here. We got one from Liu Kang Butterball, sends $10, says, you can milk anything with nipples, even Turtle Boy. Oh, man, all the nipple talk around here. Yikes. Thank you. Justin Green sends $25, says, for rent a room in Canton and run for select board. Oh, my God, I totally should. That'd be so funny if I ran against Chris Albert. Justin Green says, for Turtle Boy riders, we'll pay for it. Well, thank you very much, Justin. I appreciate that. Okay, so let's talk about, and if anyone else wants to donate, the link is at the top. You click on that, donate whatever amount of money you want, write a message. I'll get the message in my email. I'll read all that to the class, or you can cash app $ Uncle Turtle Boy and do the same thing. Okay, so let's read this. Let's listen to Helena Rafferty share. Okay, so obviously we listen to some of these people. Let's just listen to Chris Albert get roasted for a minute and just enjoy this, because this is too good.
if you could just give your name and address.
Trish Boyden, 26 Farm Street. Two comments regarding my beloved community. First, the criminal investigation into John O'Keefe's death has brought to light a lot of egregious behavior on behalf of the Canton Police Department. I read about the Lo Pilato case and saw that the town had settled back in 2007 with our taxpayer dollars. Police Chief Bright didn't let go of the three officers named in the case. We know one of the officers was the first officer to enter the Albert home the morning after O'Keefe's death. And then from the evidence in solo cups to the lack of evidence in the morning to the sudden broken glass in the afternoon, the whole case seems suspect and it points to police corruption. Why am I bringing this up? Because it impacts every single Canton citizen. It will impact our property values. People read about this case and the curious lack of leadership in this town and will not consider moving into this town because of the unaddressed police corruption and or ineptness. If police chiefs Bright, Berkowitz, and now Rafferty can't get a handle on their force, it's up to you, the select board. I'd like to see an agenda item on one of the next select board meetings to discuss how we as community handle this. I think there needs to be an independent audit of the force. And I know it's gonna cost money, but when we settled, it cost hundreds of thousands of dollars in 2007. My second point is
regarding here we go.
Board member Chris Albert.
Yes, give it to him.
According to the Norfolk County Registry of Deeds, he accumulated $65,000 in tax liens on his property and business. I don't know about you folks. I don't feel comfortable with him making any kind of financial decision on Canton's $140 million-plus municipal budget. He has a history of legal trouble from leaving the scene of a vehicular homicide, an accident he caused, to being involved in a bar fight. During the campaign, Ooh. He had zero transparency, radio silence at Candidates Night on Canton Cable. He didn't bother to answer questions submitted by Sustainable Canton. What does he stand for? Why do he want to be on the board at this juncture in his life?
Yes,
I
good question.
The right thing. Tell me he should resign. He's making a mockery of the board.
Yes, he is.
And of the town.
Like he just sits there and gets roasted. It's great. Now, that was that. Now, there was another one we got to get to here. What's this one?
You can hear me?
This guy does great too.
I want to reiterate a little bit of what the other gentleman said, that I'm disgusted with the town selectman's behavior and silence. There is no leadership being shown. The reputation of Canton is in the toilet.
True.
Across the state, if not the country. And it's only going to get worse now that things are going on to national television, the news.
That's the thing. It's like with this, like, just look at these guys. Like, when they stand up here, like, I don't know this guy. But he looks sharp. The other woman looks sharp. She looks like a, you know what I mean? Like they speak well. So this isn't, you can't say, they can't discredit this as like a movement of idiotic yahoos. Like everybody who speaks is articulate and looks, you know, well put together. And then, you know, they're like, well, respected in town, you know, they're civically engaged. So they can't say that this is a movement of trashy, stupid people. Like you're not, that's not going to work this time. It's like you're insulting smart people and they're not buying it. So, you know,
camera crews down here all the time.
Yeah. Like
there's a selectman who may or may not have a conflict of interest. He should resign.
Yes, resign. Yeah.
It would go a long way to the reputation of this town. You guys are hired help.
Yes.
You work for me.
Yes.
Us. And you're not doing your job.
No, you're not.
A lot of people in this town would agree with me.
Yeah.
Do something. Speak up and be leaders. Thank you.
Yeah. So I want you to listen carefully to this one. A lot of people have pointed this one out.
There. Anyways, you know, we're all talking about the select board. We're talking about the credibility of Canton as a town, the Lopalato, I don't know that name, that case, and the behaviors that were in it. And I'm just going to ask directly rather than, I know you're not going to answer, but the behaviors that we've seen, that one of the women mentioned the whole list of cases and foreclosures and everything else. I think I'm just going to ask directly, Mr. Albert, will you resign?
I don't think so.
Save this town.
Drinking his iced coffee.
Will you save this town?
That's a hard no. That's a hard no.
I think that might be out of order.
It might be out of
order. It might be. You might be, but fuck it. Oh, I didn't miss the best part there. Okay. I cut myself off. So I got another tape of that we have to listen to now before we go any further. Hold on. I got it here somewhere. Is this it? Give me one sec. I sent it to myself. I downloaded it. This is the one I asked people about before. I think I sent it. Did I send it to myself? Hold on. The famous line that a lot of people in Canton are talking about. Did it go through? Oh, great. It's taking a minute to send. We'll get to it. Before we get to that, I'll show you another video that we need to watch. Of John Connolly, who looks like he's about to explode. Like, that's the best way I can. He's been on the select board for like 34 years, this dude. And he spoke at Chief Berkowitz's graduation or whatever. The circle jerk, I just called it. The one where Morrissey was at with Brian Albert and Brian Higgins, and they were all there. And there was a woman by the name of, I'm going to get her name wrong. There's so many names. But she got up and spoke, and I guess she's like a well-respected person in town. And before I play this one, maybe I should play the other one first. Let me play this version of it first. Actually, I'll play this version. And then we'll watch that one. This is the last meeting. Tara Schumann, that's it. Okay, look at that. Isn't this Gallagher? Isn't this the guy? Oh, it was muted. Oh, thank you. So you missed that whole thing. Thank you for messaging me. Okay, hold on. All right, hold on. I got to replay that whole thing. Let me try it this way. Everyone's like, no sound. Yeah, I got it.
Ask one very quick question. You're coming before the board here at a time when the board and your department is under very significant scrutiny. My question is simply whether your decision to ask for these particular funds considered any of the recent concerns that some citizens in Canton and beyond have had involving the integrity of the action or inaction of the Canton Police.
So now let's watch that again with just John Connolly's reaction to it. Let's watch this.
Okay.
at 32 Wildwood Drive. And I just want to ask one very quick question. You're coming before the board here at a time when the board and your department is under very significant scrutiny. My question is simply whether your decision to
It's just like that, like, fuck that guy. That ass bag. So his name's John Connolly. And it's just like, she's just like, they're just dismissing concerns. For like, oh, stupid woman. You don't even know anything. I've been on this, like, what are you talking about? It's not like Datelines here. It's not like, you know, documentaries are being done about this whole thing. No, no, things are fine in Canton, you stupid lady. You don't know what you're talking about, dum-dum. Just the dismissiveness of it all. It's like, dude, who do you think you are? So anyway, that wasn't good. Now, there was another video from the other day, and people picked up on it. Let me pull it up here. So at the end of that speech I just showed you, where the lady Rita asked for Chris Albert to resign, something was picked up again on a hot mic. And you got to hear this. Listen to this. Listen to this. Wait, wait, did that?
Save this town.
Could you guys hear that?
Will you save this town and resign tonight?
Okay, so let me, again, when I plug the earphones in for some reason, the audio doesn't work. I don't get it. Whatever. Play it one more time.
Mr. Albert, will you resign? And save this town. Listen, will you save this town and resign tonight?
Listen.
Yeah, I think that might be out of order.
It might be out of order.
So,
Hear that? Listen. What do you say? That's John Connolly. Did you guys hear that? What do you guys think he said in the comment? What do you think he said there? I know what I heard. What'd you guys hear there? I'll play it one more time.
Out of order.
It might be out of order.
So,
he said fucking random citizens. Again, one more time.
Yeah. Fucking random citizens.
Fucking random citizens, he said. Like, that's what he thinks of you people in Canton. It's like, you're just some random citizen. He rolled his eyes at that Tara woman. And then this Rita lady, he's just like, she's just a fucking random citizen. And who the fuck is she? She's not even on the select board. Who is she? She has no right to have opinions, or she doesn't know anything. Like, this is how brazen these people are. Like, that guy probably doesn't go on the internet ever. Doesn't know what social media is, probably has no fucking clue. That guy, John Connolly, is such a boomer. Like, I guarantee he reads a hard copy of the newspaper every day. That's where he gets his news from. Probably reads the Canton Citizen front to cover every day. And if it's not in there, he doesn't know it exists. So, like, this whole, like, most of this stuff is going online. So, like, if you're that guy, you don't know. How big a deal is this? So, like, he's just like, what? Oh, this is a big deal. People think this is a big deal. Well, there's nothing. There's nothing in the newspaper today. It wasn't even in the funnies. There was nothing about it. And they read next to Garfield and Friends. He was funny today, but she's not funny. So this guy just on a hot mic, just fucking random citizens. These people know what they're talking about. These people don't know what they're talking about. Except they do. Except they do. So people are upset about that. So you know what? I got his number. Should we give him a call? Let's give John Connolly a call. I got a bunch of, we're making some calls tonight. Let's give him a call. Okay. Helena's calling right now. Don't answer, John. Don't answer. Come on, please answer. Oh yeah, it's way past his bedtime, isn't it?
You have reached
John Connolly.
Hi, John Connolly. This is a random fucking citizen calling you. Just want to see what you're up to right now. Want to talk about the controversy that's going on in your town and why you rolled your eyes at that very nice lady who was just expressing her opinions and asking questions of the board. So I wanted to talk. Maybe you're not aware of it. See, there's this thing called the internet. I understand a man of your stature probably really doesn't know how to work the internet machine, but on this internet thing, there's people from all over the world who are talking about what's happening in your town right now. And it's not good news. It's actually the opposite. It's really, really bad. And you're sitting next to the, I don't know if the guy next to you, they call him Chicken Parm Charlie. That guy killed someone. I don't know if you know that. He literally killed someone. And now it looks like his son might have done the same thing too. So it runs in the family. I don't know if you're aware of that. But he also called me a loser. I came to stimulate your economy one day. I was going to buy his mediocre chicken parm. I'd be the first. And he kicked me out of the store. He called me a loser. And then some other lady wore a free Karen Reed shirt to the waterfall ball and grill. She's trying to stimulate the economy. And guess what? He calls her a loser and accuses her of giving me a blowjob. Did you know that, John? Yeah, that's happening in your town. So you got to get on this, John. So, you know, I just want to talk about this. Maybe I'm thinking about coming to a meeting soon. I'm not a random fucking citizen, though. I'm a little bit more. I'm an award-winning journalist. I don't know if you know about that. I'm an award-winning journalist. So I'm going to have some questions for you and for your buddy Chicken Parm Charlie. And I think there's going to be a lot of people there. Like you're going to need a bigger town hall. You're going to need a bigger town hall. So give me a call back when you get this, pal. And, you know, take good care of yourself. You look like you're in great shape. We'll talk soon. Bye. We'll see if he calls back. Okay. Okay. So that was him. And actually, I got his work number too, but I don't know if he's in it. Maybe he'll answer this. Maybe he's burning the midnight oil. What does he even do for work? This can't be a full-time job, right?
Hello. We can help you find another business in the area. Since the number you called is not in service.
Okay, his business went out of business. That's a good sign. Oh, God. Okay. We got some other phone numbers here. Should we make some calls? Oh, they're gonna get on each other now. I'm not even saying who I'm calling first. I guarantee they're in that group right now. Don't answer the phone. He's calling. I'm not even gonna say who I'm calling. We're gonna start with the first one here. Okay, I'm not even gonna say. Okay, here we go. Come on. These are ones we haven't called before. I got more numbers.
Automatic voice message system 6177191433 is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hi, Diana White. This is award-winning journalist Turtle Boy. You can call me Dr. Turtle Boy if you'd like. Some people call me Aiden. People call you Fupasaurus, I'm apparently aware of now. I was at the event the other day. We had a rolling rally through your town. And it became clear that you or your daughter threw an egg at us. And I want to know what's up with that. More than anything, I want to know, like, was the egging planned? Like, did you go out shopping for eggs just for us? Or do you just routinely drive around with eggs in your car? Like, that's what I'm just randomly want. And, like, were you at all worried that, like, when you threw an egg in front of the police station with all these people filming, that might not be the best idea in the world? I know that you've since thrown your daughter under the bus and blamed it on her. And now you've put the burden on the victim to decide whether or not they want to press charges against the child, which is really cowardly of you. But I just want to know what's up with that. I assume you're hitting the sauce right now pretty heavily. It is 9:50. The night is young. I get that. You're probably shaking that 3-ton ass of yours down somewhere. And looking for the next baby daddy. I know it is, but, give me a call back when you get this. If you need a lawyer, I know a guy named David United. He might be able to help you out. He's pretty good. So give me a call. Bye. We'll see if she calls me back. Now they're going to start chirping. He's making calls. Don't answer your phone. On that note, let's get this party started. Here we go. Canton Roulette. Let's go. All right. Now's the fun part. Here we go. I'm not even going to say who each call is. Oh, this one's definitely not answering.
Hello?
Yeah, live to tape. Hi, is this Jill?
It's Turtle Boy.
It's Turtle Boy. Is this Jill Daniels?
Oh.
What are you doing, Jill? Are you at all worried that your godson, Colin, is going to go to jail?
Do you understand that Colin wasn't even there? Do you understand you're a fucking piece of shit?
Really?
Do you understand you're going to jail?
Why am I going to jail for?
You want to know? Okay, can we have a conversation right now?
Yeah, let's have...
Turtle.
Yeah, let's have a conversation. So what is your evidence that Colin wasn't there?
He's online right now.
Yeah, who's this?
Oh, fuck yourself, you fucking homo.
Who's that? Is that not so emblematic of who these people are? Is that not Canton in a nutshell right there? They're obviously drunk. He's not going to jail. You're going to... Let's call her back. We're calling her back right now. Hey.
Go to hell. Back. Take care of your kids, you fucking loser. Go away.
You loser? Who are you? Is this Julie? She called me a fucking loser. She called me a loser. Call again.
Seriously, what do you want with me?
I just want to know one thing.
Find out that Karen Reed is a fucking killer. Why do you keep calling me? Why don't you get a life and fucking focus on your
children? I just want to know one thing. So what evidence do you have that Colin wasn't there? What evidence do you have?
What evidence do you have that he was there?
Brian Albert's grand jury testimony said that he was there.
Tom Beattie and Aaron Beattie, guess what?
No, Brian Albert said that. Brian Albert said that Colin was in the house.
You think you're so right about everything?
I know I'm right. I've seen it.
No, you're not.
I have the documents. I'm looking at it right now. How am I a piece of shit? Your son... Where was he? What evidence do you have? Okay, let's have a conversation. Okay. So what evidence do you... Can I ask you something? What evidence...
Turtle Boy, what the fuck is your name? Fucking Aiden? What is your name?
My name's Aiden.
Aiden,
you can call me Aiden. You can call me Doctor,
no,
but...
I want to call you a dickhead because that's what you are.
Okay.
You are a piece of shit. Do you know that?
I disagree.
Okay, are you taping me? Because that's illegal.
I said live to tape. Yes, we're live to tape. I've said that.
You're live. Okay. Well, let me say this right now to you really quick, okay?
Okay.
My nephew and Brian Albert and Jen Albert are not fucking guilty. Your little good lover that you're banging or you fucking want to bang.
Who?
Guess what?
Who?
She's... Oh, Karen.
You think I want to bang Karen? That's why you think that's why I'm doing this?
Yeah, okay. Guess what? The cat's out of the bag, dude, okay?
What's out of the bag?
I don't know how you got my number. You're a creep. You call me, you call my family, you call whatever. Why are you such a creep?
Can I just ask you something? One question.
What
evidence do you have that Colin was not in the house? Serious question.
What evidence do you have that he was? That's a serious question.
So, okay, I have a...
That's a serious question. What do you have that he was in the house?
Brian Albert's grand jury testimony.
Brian Albert's grand testimony was that Colin was in the house. Where is the grand... No, shut the fuck up. Once in your life, seriously, you don't know how to shut up. You're a fucking troll that fucking trolls everybody because you have no life, you have no clear friends, and you freaking focus on your kids. You have two kids.
I do. They're lovely.
Yeah, and your wife hates you, so
okay.
Like, whatever.
But that's... You're changing the subject.
Beside the point. Yeah, no, change the subject, really?
Yeah.
You are a blogger. First of all, I got to ask you this one thing, because this is one thing I've always wanted to ask you. Where's your award? Your award-winning journalist. Where's that award?
Oh, I'm the 2017 Worcester County Best Media Outlet.
6 years later.
Well, it still counts.
Why don't you produce that? You fucking...
I have.
Friggin' piece of
I've
shit.
Didn't done guess blogs what? About
okay,
it.
Okay, guess what? Shut the fuck up.
Oh, sorry. Okay, sorry.
Do you know how to shut up? Do you ever know how to shut up?
I'm trying.
I'm asking you right now, do you?
Sometimes.
Okay, no, you don't, because you're a fucking loser. Oh, I went to Truro because somebody gave me a thing. Dude, you have
people,
you call yourself a turtle. A turtle. Do you know what that means? A turtle. Guess what?
We're getting a little off.
We're
getting a little off track.
Shut the fuck up.
Whoa, you're so angry. Why are you so angry?
Oh, I'm angry because I'm so sick of you. You have ruined so many people's fucking lives when Karen fucking killed him. Karen did. And you know what? The truth is going to come out. You know what? Fucking Turtle Boy ate it.
Well, but can I read the grand jury testimony right here?
Wait, excuse me?
It says Colin, I'm reading grand jury testimony. It says Colin Albert was Colin, also.
Guess what? Shut the fuck up, you fucking loser.
I can't even talk.
Colin was in the house, but he wasn't there when everybody came back from the party.
According to Brian and Nicole Albert's testimony before the grand jury, their nephew, Colin Albert, was also present.
Colin Albert was in the house, but prior to when John and Brian and Higgins and actually, one question. Why do you only start? Why is it guilty until proven innocent? Why is that? What about Higgins? What about everybody? Like
Higgins? What you want? Why are you turning on Higgins?
No, I'm asking you. I'm saying there was six people in the house. Why are you focusing on Brian and Colin only? Colin was in the house.
I feel like I've given Jen a pretty significant amount of time.
Enter the goddamn house, and you know that.
Then how did his phone go up and down? Then how did his phone go up and downstairs then? If Karen didn't go in the house, I mean, if John didn't go in the house, then why did his phone go up and downstairs? Dude. Did that just happen? We're calling her back in a minute. But again, it says right, because all this shit about Colin wasn't in the house. It's all a lie. Colin, this is the new thing that they're spreading. Colin wasn't in the house. We have evidence. This is what Krusty Panties has told them. And when Krusty Panties talks, you can assume that it comes directly from, Jill Daniels and Gemma Cabe. And that's Jill Daniels in the flesh right there. That's what she's like. We're getting a call back. Hold on. Bad connection?
No, not bad connection, you fucking douchebag. Guess what? You're not a journalist. You're nobody. You're a fucking.
I feel like I'm somebody.
You're trying to solve. If you're so good, why aren't you a cop or a lawyer? Because you're an asshole. Colin was not there. Brian didn't do anything. Jen didn't do anything. Karen Reed ran him over.
I know you keep saying that, but you don't have any evidence of that.
I do keep saying that because that's the fucking truth. I'm so sick of you fucking ridiculing every single goddamn person in my family in this world. If somebody disagrees with you, guess what you do?
Well, it's not hard. Just don't kill someone and I'll like you. You know? It's not a high bar.
Shut up. Have you ever shut up in your life?
I feel like you've done most of the talking, in fairness. Okay, sorry. So, whoa, take it easy. Easy, okay, pussycat.
You know what, turtle boy, you fucking turtle. Go get a new name, okay, you fucking turtle douche. I am done. Colin didn't do it. Brian didn't do it. Jen didn't do it. No one did it. Your fucking bitch Karen did it. So fucking lay on that and fucking figure that out. Go fuck.
Well, can I ask you, but seriously, though. Dude, this is going to, they're so stupid. Do you understand what Karen's lawyers are going to do with this audio? What would just happen right there? Do you understand that? How helpful this is to the Karen Reed defense team, what just happened right now? She called me back. Easy, pussycat. Easy. Like, look at, again, this is the Krusty Panties lie that they've been repeating, is that Colin Albert left at 12:10 and with a girl, a friend. They don't say who that friend is. They claim that she has 360 data on her app proving this. They haven't shown it, of course. And they claim, this is the kicker, that there is odd video from the Canton Library at 12:14 showing Colin Albert going past the Canton Library. So it worked when Colin went there. And of course, they haven't shown any of this. Of course, like, why would they haven't shown any of this? They just say it. And what you just heard from her right there, that is them in a nutshell. Trashy, drunk, and best of all, they cannot back up anything they're saying. They don't have any facts on their side. So all they can do is be like, you want to fuck. They want to talk about my person. Like, they just talk about you. They attack the source. This is what they do to anyone. This is what they've done to people like Angela Chin O'Donnell and anyone else in town who has spoken out. That's how they treat you. The satisfaction I got from that mental breakdown that you heard right there. That's why I do what I do, folks. That's why I do what I do. That is a trashy person who deserves to be exposed. And she just exposed herself to us. And I love the comment about Higgins there. Like, that just reaffirmed. They don't trust Higgins. They assumed Higgins ratted on them. This is ending, man. I'm telling you. The end is coming soon. Like, what you just heard right there is a woman who's having a mental breakdown because her nephew is about to be arrested for murder. That's what it sounds like to me. We'll call her back one more time. She'll probably, who knows, she'll pick up. Live to tape, hello?
I'm going to tell you right now, if you call me one more time, I'm seriously, like, leave me alone.
What are you going to do?
Like, you, I actually hate, really? Are you threatening me?
No, now? No, but I'm asking really? You, I asked you what you said, if I call you one more time.
Leave me alone,
what?
Don't call me, I hate you. You are dead to me, I hate you. Colin didn't do it, Jen didn't do it. When you find out that Karen did it, I can't wait till you fucking
But Karen,
everybody.
Why would I go to jail?
Bye-bye.
What crime did I commit? What crime did I commit? Why do you guys all say that? Oh my God. One more time. She picks up. She picks up.
Seriously, stop harassing me. Go away.
But I'm not harassing you. I just want to ask you. I have a you're the one. Like, what the hell? Is she going to try to get an order on me too? I have some questions. I'm a journalist. Live the tape.
Again.
I just have a question. I have a question. 5 seconds. 5 seconds. She's not fearing. I'm an award-winning journalist. She can block me. 2 seconds of your time. 2 seconds.
Please leave your message for 7-8-1-7-6-0-8-4-9-5.
Hey, Jill, this is Aiden Carney, the award-winning journalist, calling you back. I think we had a bad connection there. I just want to say I really enjoyed our conversation tonight. I think it was really helpful for some people. It was really enlightening having that conversation with you. I didn't really appreciate the personal jabs you threw about me. I thought that was unnecessary stuff about my personal life, you know, because people in glass houses and all. But I guess the big disconnect here was over Colin and his whereabouts that night. I was just wondering why he dropped out of school if he didn't do anything wrong, if he's not in any sort of trouble or anything like that. Why would he do something so drastic and give up something that he obviously loved doing, and that's playing football? And also, the grand jury testimony from Brian Albert is that Colin was there. So just what's the disconnect with that? I believe your spokesperson, Krusty Panties, they call her. She stated that there's some sort of 360 app that shows that Brian was not in the house, or that Colin had left with some unnamed woman at 12:10. If you could show that to me, that'd be great. And I'd be happy to clear Colin's name. I'd be happy to clear Colin's name. So if you could do that for me, that would be swell. So give me a call. Bye. Well, that was interesting. Certainly. So yeah, that was pretty cool. Wasn't expecting that. I got a couple more people we can call too. I want to read Kabir. I wrote down a couple questions. Like, I want to, on that note, I would like to make an offer to these losers. These losers. Do they all say that? I can't believe that happened. I want to make an offer here to the Alberts, McCabes, all those people. Okay. I will end what I'm doing right now. I will admit that Karen Reed possibly killed John O'Keefe if you can do the following. Okay. And I feel like this isn't a big goal. Like, I will take down anything I said about Colin. I will apologize and I'll shut down the blog forever if you can do the following. Number one, can you show me the Life 360 data that Colin was not at Fairview when John O'Keefe was? That's number one. That should be pretty easy to do, because you said you have that. If you can get that to me, I'll take down all the blogs about Colin. Done. Number two, any texts, emails, or voicemails from John O'Keefe saying that he wanted to break up with Karen Reed? Because I've heard that a lot, that John was, you know, Karen's a crazy bitch. You guys keep saying that. She's horrible. I've seen a lot of pictures that have suggested the opposite. So if you could clear that up for me, I will take all these blogs down. Not a problem. So just get that to me and I'll help, because I'm fair. I'm fair and balanced. So just get that to me. Number three, do you have any evidence that Karen was drunk on January 28th? That's number three. Like actual evidence of that. Can you show me the videos of her taking nine shots or whatever? Just show this to me. I'd love to see them. Number four, do you have any evidence that Fairview was or was not plowed between 12 and 6 a.m. on January 29th? Do you have any evidence of that? If you think it was not plowed, feel free to share it with me. And I will retract everything I said about Lucky Loughran, because I'll assume he's lying, right? If you can just prove that to me. Number five, do you have any evidence in any trial in any state in the country where an expert testified for the defendant for free? Because you guys are claiming that this Richard Green fella, who's an expert in his field, is only doing so because he's a hired gun for the defense. But it seems as if experts get paid. That's what they do. So you have any examples of experts who work for free? And I'll take it down. Number six, do you have any evidence in any trial in any state where the defense attorney has not previously represented accused or convicted felons? Because that's you guys have made a lot of comments about Alan Jackson, that he represented Harvey Weinstein and other shady people. Do you have any evidence? Are you aware of any attorneys, defense attorneys, who have not represented scummy people? Okay. Number seven. Do you have any evidence in any trial in any state where the defense attorney paid a member of the press to report favorably on his client? Because that is another accusation that you've made. Several people have made that I'm just being paid by the defense to say what I say. Do you have any other examples of when that has ever happened? And I'll take it down. Number eight, do you have any proof? Because you guys have made a lot of allegations that Karen Reed is a crazy bitch. And specifically, Krusty Panties has stated, and when she states things, it comes from you, that Karen Reed has ex-boyfriends that will attest to how crazy she is. So, do you have any evidence or proof of an ex-boyfriend of Karen Reed's who was the victim of domestic violence, which is what Krusty Panties recently accused her of? And it, again, she speaks for you. We know that. If you can do that for me, that would be great. And I'll be happy to expose what a crazy bitch Karen Reed is. That's all. That's all. So if you could do those things, I'll gladly clear that up. No problem. No problem. I'd be happy to do that. Now, I'll tell you one person who is on my side with Karen Reed. He's a certain attorney. And he represents somebody on your team. Let me see if I have these messages. Oh, there it is. Oh. Okay, let's see what this says. Let's see what this says. Okay. Now, I never told Kevin this was off. He asked me to be off the record. I go, shoot. I never said this is off the record. I'm like, what do you, shoot? You messaged me about this? Shoot. Okay, so let me show you these messages here from Kevin Reddington, the attorney for, and I don't think I've showed anyone these messages. This is the attorney for Jennifer McCabe. Okay? And again, we got off on the wrong foot because he said he wanted to dance with me. I forget the other things he said about me. Whatever. Now, this is what he messaged me a couple weeks ago. I'll show you. You do a great job. Much respect. You created Karen's innocence. No one else created and shown. So there's Jennifer McCabe's attorney telling me, an award-winning journalist, that he believes that Karen Reed is innocent. And if Kevin Reddington believes that Karen Reed is innocent, by default, that means he's essentially saying that Jennifer McCabe is guilty. Because if Karen Reed didn't kill him, then someone in the house did. And she was in the house. So there you go, Jill Daniels. This is, it's not just me who's thinking that. It's your own people's lawyers. He said that, I agree. I know Dave Vianetti, great guy and attorney. But I'm the one that did this. I'm an incredible reporter. And I said, thanks a lot, Kevin. That's very nice of you. It's very nice. It's very respectful of Kevin. So there's that. There's that. I know. I got to bring up the award. I like of all that's the thing. Like, that's your concern right now. Like, your nephew's going to jail, could be going to jail for life. And you're like, but where's your award, Turtle Boy? Why do you call yourself a turtle? I don't know. It's like, I feel like you got bigger problems than that, but that's just me. That's just me. And then Kevin, he actually asked me for the help in the Lindsey Clancy case. I'm like, Kevin, I wrote about Lindsey Clancy already. I was like kind of sympathetic towards her, even for somebody who killed a bunch of her kids, you know? So that's cool. That's cool. Thank you, Kevin Reddington. I appreciate that. Again, you know, that I only bring that up because I think that's incredibly relevant. People want more calls. Let's do it. Let's do some more calls. I got one right now. This is no one's going to see this one coming. Who was that guy with her? Was that Nick Moraitis?
Please leave your message for 5088462092.
Hi, this message is for Trish Lank, the wife of Michael Lank. I've been trying to reach your husband for a while. This is award-winning journalist Aiden Carney from Turtle Boy Daily News. I want to know, I was looking to find out, what did Jennifer McCabe call your husband about at 8:38 in the morning? And what did she say? And when she brought him back to the house at 34 Fairview Road, what did they talk about? And also, why did he respond to the house if he wasn't on duty? And why did he immediately assume that Sandra Birchmore killed herself as well? And also, why is he still on the force if 20 years ago he was involved in a lawsuit with the Lapito brothers, whatever their names are. And he again clocked in on duty after being four, you know, beers deep, and decided that he was going to arrest a couple of people to defend Chris Albert. Kind of weird. So if you could give me a call back, or if Mike can give me a call back, that would be great. Talk to you soon. Bye. So we'll see. We're calling some randoms, dude. We're doing it. Okay, we got another one here. Got another one. Okay. They're all warning each other right now. I'm telling you. They're all like, don't. He's calling everyone. I just have some questions. I feel like I've been pretty fair. Is it okay? There's nothing private about it. I never guaranteed him private. Like, who messages Turtle Boy and expects it to stay private? Like, dude.
Hello?
Yes, we're live to tape. Is this Heather? Hello? Heather, this is award-winning journalist Aiden Carney from Turtle Boy Daily News. This is Heather Sullivan, the Canton High School employee. Hello, Heather? She didn't answer. Oh, that's too bad. Heather, we can get to her in a little bit. She's the Canton High School employee who's a little inappropriate with the students that they say she's in that bully group that, you know, shares whatever about there. Heather Rodding Sullivan. So she did not answer. Let's try another one. We got another guy here. I don't think I've ever tried this one before. which is surprising. Boy, this episode's going to go down in history, isn't it? Okay, you guys are getting your money's worth tonight.
Child is not in service.
What?
If you feel you've received this message in error, please hang up and try your call again later.
Of course, Tim Albert doesn't pay his cell phone bill. Okay, so that didn't work. Got another number here. Let's play this one. All right. Matt Carano.
Please leave your message for 6.
Okay, now she's not that important. That's Meg Kennedy. She didn't answer. All right, what else? Who do we got? She's going to find out. Oh, my God, Turtle Boy called me. Yep, good thing you didn't answer. They're probably all messaging each other right now. Now, I got another one. We got another one here. And we're going to talk, but I'm just going to call this one right now. I haven't told you what this person did yet. We'll see if they answer.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
I'll try one more time. I don't have Helena's phone number. She's watching right now. Helena watches every episode. So Helena's like, he's going to call me next, isn't he? If somebody wants to send me your number, I'll call her. This is old school. Yeah, nothing.
Automatic voice message system 508-494-9762 is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hi, this message is for Erin O'Keefe, the wife of Paul O'Keefe. This is award-winning journalist Aidan Carney calling from Turtle Boy Daily News. I'm calling because it came to my attention today that you called a local business in Taunton that was selling some yard signs to help Karen Reed's defense fund. And it appears as if you called them up and harassed them for that. And I'm wondering why you did that. Now, it's strange that you've never tried to contact me, seeing as I'm really leading the charge here for the Free Karen Reed movement. And instead, you're going after some poor lady who's just trying to run her business and just believes in Karen Reed's innocence and is trying to help her out. So I'm wondering, you know, why you're doing that and what your hatred for Karen Reed comes from. And I'm also wondering, when your husband, Paul, was arrested for DUI 3 years ago when he almost killed that elderly man drunk driving in the middle of the day, I'm just wondering why Karen was the one who bailed him out of jail and not you. Because, you know, you're his wife. So I'm just wondering why you did that. I'm also wondering, when is the last time you saw John O'Keefe before he died? Did you and John get along? Were you friends? Did you ever babysit his kids? Did you ever spend any time with them? Because John took those two kids in and, you know, he's a single guy. You guys are married. You had like a stable thing. Why didn't you take them in? You didn't even try, did you? So I'm just wondering why now you're not only pretend. And I know you guys are grieving. That's a big thing. I'm told we can't talk to you guys or be mean to you because you're grieving. And I'm wondering, what part of the grieving process do you go around and start harassing local businesses for selling yard signs for innocent people? Is that like step 5 of the grieving process? Are you almost done with the grieving? Is this a sign that you are done? Or is this just grieving? I've never been in a situation before where a house full of people killed my brother-in-law, who I didn't even like anyway, and left him on the lawn to die and then framed an innocent woman. So I can't relate. I can't relate to your scenario. So just give me a call back when you get this. Bye. Oh, yeah. And also, where's the money? That's another thing I like to know. Where's the GoFundMe money? Where's the $370,000 that was raised for the Furbush children that your husband was the beneficiary of? That I would like to know that too, because, you know, Karen Reed set up a trust fund for them, a couple million dollars in it. They're financially taken care of. They're going to collect Social Security. Those kids are in good hands. And then Paul was the beneficiary of, I'm just wondering why the trust fund was not the beneficiary. Like, why didn't that money go to them? Why did it need to go in Paul's hands first? I'm not saying that Paul took it all. I'm not saying Paul took it all and spent it on himself or whatever. I'm not saying that, but it's a lot of money And is there any accounting for it? Or are we just not allowed to ask that because you're a grieving family who harasses small businesses? And we didn't even talk about that. So there is a business in Taunton. It's right on the Taunton Lakeville line. Great people run it. And they support Karen Reed. And so they had a big thing today where they were giving away, like, I think it was like 50 buttons. They ordered like 50 buttons from our store. And like, first people get them. The free Karen Reed buttons. And they're also selling the yard signs. And they almost sold out of those today. And a lot of people went down there. And poor Erica, the owner of this business, is just harassed. And like, she was like, a couple people called her. There was one other person that called her too. Let me get that number. And they said horrible things to this woman. They didn't even say it to her. They said it to her, like the person, the girl, like the 17-year-old who answers the phones. That's what they were saying to this woman. Like, I don't deal well with bullies. That's the thing you people don't know, is like, that you people should know. It's like, I don't deal with bullies. Like, you guys are the bullies. Like, you saw Jill Daniels there. I bully the bullies. Yeah, that they basically, they said, they did the whole thing about like, oh, we used to go here a lot, but we're not going here anymore. Bullshit. You've never been there before in your life. Whenever somebody says that, they've never been there before in their life. And they said that they gave negative reviews over it. So by the way, that's called, I don't want to get the name of this place wrong. I think it's the Star Drive-In in Taunton. Go say something. Give them a good review. Will you? Go give them a good review. Even if you've never been there before, give them a good review. Be like, it's freaking great here. I love it. Best place in the world. Because they never been there either. And they gave negative reviews. So we need to give them positive reviews. Let's answer their negativity with positivity. And Aaron was apparently very aggressive towards a 17-year-old, by the way. These are the people we're supposed to feel bad for. Oh, no, he's a grieving victim. And then they're harassing 17-year-olds. And they said that they demanded to know from the 17-year-old girl, why is it free Karen Reed when she's not incarcerated, but she should be? And basically telling her, like, you're a bitch, like, fuck you guys, and called a few times. And they didn't know who it was at first. They're like, who the fuck is this? And they looked at the car, they look at the call log, and it's to an Aaron O'Keefe. And that's her phone number. I've verified that is Aaron O'Keefe's phone number. So I'm just wondering, Aaron, I know you're watching right now because your husband watches every episode. And we can have a conversation the next day outside of court. Now that I know that the grieving process is over and we're on to the harassment phase, we can have a longer conversation about why you're doing that. And, you know, just how much you loved. Tell me the five favorite things you loved about John O'Keefe. Tell me your five favorite memories of him in the last year before he died. Tell me the five things that you and John did together and talked about that you will remember most, because I know you guys were so close. I know you guys were so close. Yeah. So yeah, there's that. Now that we're doing it, now that we're doing phone calls, I got another one. You know, we never talk about, and I don't think these are bad people at all, but I think we should have a conversation with them. When Ryan Nagel pulled up behind Karen Reed that night, he was not driving. A lot of people think he was. He was not driving. He was in a truck with two other people that we never talk about. And Ryan Nagel is a great witness for Karen Reed because he said that John O'Keefe was not inside the car, not outside the car. Therefore, he had to be inside the house. Case closed. And we never talk about these two people. So let's see if they got something to say. Let's see what they got something to say, shall we? Let's do it. Hi, is this Richie? Hello? Hello? Oh, he hung up. Bad connection? Hello?
Please leave your message for...
Okay, so there's that. Let's try the other one. This is was Ryan Nagel's girlfriend at the time, but they've broken up. See what she's got to say. She was in the truck, too. Okay. We'll call her another time. So I just thought maybe those are good. Those are like, they're useful. They're not bad. Those ones. Jill Daniels. Was that the greatest call in the history of Turtle Boy? Like that's up there. The Jill Daniels calls. We're going to be referencing the Jill Daniels call for decades, man. But remember the Jill Daniels call? That shit was nuts. Nuts. Okay. All right. So anyway, let me read a couple turtle chats here. Man, we got a bunch now. I got to bang through these. All right, here we go. First one's KC sends $10, says, hey, doctor, we know she didn't do it. So when she hit John with her car, when she hit J.O.'s car, wouldn't there be pieces in her driveway? A lot of people have said that, but I can't be a hunt. First of all, the Canton police are the ones that said there was no, or the state police are the ones that said there was no tail light in their driveway, so we don't know that. Number two, if you look at the video when they're coming out, it's really not much of a break at all. And number three, I've seen a lot of people show pictures of tail lights on Lexuses when they break and they invert in, so like it wouldn't even come out. I don't know, I'd have to see it, but that's a question I've been asked before. James sends $10, says hang them fucking high. Will do, James, appreciate that. Lauren number two sends $10, says Dr. Turtle Boy heart emoji. Thank you, Lauren number two. I appreciate that. Big Sween from Canton sends $10, says thanks for your hard work. Not easy being a doctor, lawyer, mayor, and investigator. Go get him, buddy. Thank you. Martha sends $50, says you're on fire tonight, doc. Salt air has a way of clearing your mind. That it does. That it does. Kelly sends $10, says they should never have told those young kids she murdered him. Obviously, it's a lie, but they've been through hell already. Why tell them someone they love that it's so sick? Because they're selfish. Because they don't give a shit about those kids. You know, you think they care about, you think that Jill Daniels cares about kids? No, they care about saving themselves. They don't give a shit about those kids. That's a lie. If they cared about those kids, they wouldn't have killed their father. Like, stop it. Sandy sends $25, says, doctor, your shirt today, class of 2023, best looking. Thanks for just being you, Tingsboro. Thank you, Cindy. I appreciate that. Thank you. Justin sends $5, says, do you have any future collaborations with the greatest man of all time, Kirk Minahane? Anything in the works? Yeah, I'd love to go on Kirk's show. I don't beg to go on shows. It's a thing. If I get invited on, I'll go. I know he has like a Friday thing with a rotation. If you guys want to tell Kirk, hey, get Turtle Boy on here, I'd be happy to go on. It'd be cool. I like talking with Kirk. I've had him on my show before. I'd be more than happy to go on his. So that'd be cool. Stephanie sends $25. And we could talk about this and we could talk about Sandra Birchmore. So it'd actually be a lot to talk about if I want on his. Stephanie sends $25. Says, keep up the good work. Thank you, Stephanie. I appreciate that. Chris from Hanover. Jeez, sends $300. Very kind of you, Chris from Hanover. $300. He says, a Turtle Boy ditty. The shiny suburban town of Canton is burning. The journalistic Jesus has a lot of heads turning. The turtle and his riders, without interruption, has condemned crooked families who thrive on corruption. God bless Turtle Boy. The avalanche is coming and Canton will never be the same. God, that was good. Journalist, journal Jesus. I love it. I'm journalist Jesus. Thank you very much, Chris. Very kind of you. Next up we have, and by the way, like Lena, a woman, I just found her this week. She did a show about my show. She's got almost the same amount of subs as us. She does true crime shit. I think she goes by Lena. It looks like we have a lot of cross following between our audiences. And email Lena. She talked about having me on or whatever, or talking. I'm not sure what she wants to do. I'd be happy to. I really enjoyed watching her stream. And I just found her channel and I sub to it as well. So I'd be happy to go on there. turtleboysports@gmail.com. You can't like DM or anything on YouTube. So like YouTube needs like a D, like it should be treated like social media. They should have like a DM function and other things like that instead of just a stream of videos. Okay. So thank you very much, Chris from Hanover. Bob sends $25, says, how do we know or can we know what Google turned up when Jen McCriminal Googled Haas Long to Diet Coke? We don't. I mean, I'd say do it yourself at this point, but by now the algorithm, because that has been such a hot topic, the algorithm for those words is you're just going to get her. I would guess if you Google that now. Lee sends $25, says your dedication to reporting the truth has single-handedly changed the local and national narrative that the media was regurgitating. This truly is award-winning journalism and the awards will keep rolling in. It's like, that's what I wanted to thank you very much. First of all, Lee. And second of all, that's what I should have told Jill Daniels. Like, first of all, when I say the award-winning journalist thing, like, like it's, I mean, I did technically win some awards, but it's kind of like a joke. Like, it's like, I say it in jet, like we 3 years in a row in my early heydays in 2015, we were voted Worcester's best blogger. I was voted Worcester's best blog. That was back when I was anonymous. Worcester, there's like a reader's choice thing. We won that. Then they got rid of the category because we wanted by it so much. And so then people voted us for Worcester County's top media outlet in 2016 and 2017. Then they just stopped doing it. So I still have, they're actually hanging in my award-winning office upstairs, Jill Daniels. I got it hanging up. The case broke. It's cracked, but I got it. I got the awards. I think Brett has one of them or somebody's got one of them. I forget who, but I have two of them still. So I did win those. So when I say award-winning journalist, yeah, I did win some awards. And I say it because it's catchy. And it's also like, it's kind of funny, but it's true also. So like, but they get so mad about it. And that makes me do it more like that. What awards have you won, turtle fucker? They get so mad about the award-winning journalist thing. Imagine like your nephew's going to jail. Like he's like, fucked. He just lost his life. And it's like, but where's your award, turtle boy? So, okay. It's in my office actually. But anyway, so thank you very much, Lee. Kelly sends $50. Says the liquor talking, messy booze bag. She confirmed Colin did it. I mean, I don't, it's like she didn't do him any favors. I'll tell you that much. Chef's kiss. Thank you, Kelly. Maureen sends $10. Says thanks for the entertainment tonight, Jillian. Oh, she's a peach. We're going to have her back on for sure. Karen sends $25. Says Mike from that chapter covered Karen Reed yesterday. He's the guy I'm talking about. He's the one with 1.8 million views, the Irishman. Credit with link to you. And you're mentioned in many comments. He has over 1.8 million subs. So he reaches a lot of people over the world. I'm telling you, man, that's what I mean by this is spreading. Like, it's too late. Cat's out of the bag, Jill. You think I'm bad? Oh, wait till, oh my God. You have no idea what you're in for. If you can't handle me, oh. Next, Hunter sends $10, says the Canton Loser crew. I can't believe she called me a loser. I just picture the conversations about me around the house. Oh, he's such a loser. He's going to get it. He's a loser. Mr. Glock sends $10, says, what about Higgins? Why is your moderator putting me on timeout? Again, don't fucking cry about the moderators to me. I don't deal with it. I get so many messages every day from people like, why did I get kicked out of the John and Karen group? I'm like, I don't fucking know. I don't run that group. They made me an admin, but it's not really my group. Like, I don't, you think I have time to get involved in that? Why you got kicked out of the group? I don't fucking know. If one of the admins kicked you out, message them, kiss their ass and figure out a way back in. Like, you can do it. Like, you don't need me. Don't come to daddy. I'm not settling your disputes. It's not happening. So I don't know why the moderators put you in timeout. And I don't know what you said about Higgins, but thank you for the $10. I addressed Higgins earlier in the show. So go back and rewind when it comes to that. Glamasoo sends $50, says, please send Jill Daniels aspirin and vitamin water for her hangover. She's going to need it. You got that right, Seuss. Skelly Jen sends $34, says, turtle boy, help. Bitch tits is trying to eat me. That would be your husband, Matt. Mike sends $10, says, get yourself a rusty trombone from Jill Daniels. Jill Daniels. Okay. I appreciate that. I think we got a couple cash apps too. Let me read these. Hell of a show tonight. Let's see what we got here. Oh man, a bunch of these. Carrie Max sends $25 says for they need to make a sign that says stop it. We might get stop it t-shirts with just I feel like the my face with like the Barack Obama hope symbol. It just says stop it. We need that. Okay. So thank you, Carrie. Melissa B sends $10 says for local moron Carl Dougal. Jill Brad Goldstein sends $100. Thank you very much, Brad. He says for Jill Daniels bar tab. That's not going to cover it, my dude, but it's a good start. It's a good start. Thank you, Brad. Carrie Andrade, or I don't want to pronounce that wrong, sends $10 says for a drink for Jill and a shout out for Joe and Diane. Thank you very much. Appreciate that, Carrie. Deanna Corby sends $10, says, for first throwing Higgins under the bus. Hashtag Jill. She did throw him under the bus. Dude, I can't wait to re-listen to that. Oh, it's going to be so good. Jake Schultz sends $10, says, for who's the mayor of Canton? Big Daddy Turtle, is that who? You're looking at him, Dr. Turtle Boy. Frank Rizzo sends $5, says, for all the dicks, Brett sucks. You're going to need a lot more than $5 for that, sir. I'm just saying. Okie dokie. And one more from Ashley sends $10, says we need another call to Jill. You fucking loser. I look forward to your lives. You're amazing. You're amazing, Ashley. I appreciate that. You're amazing. And one more from Kathleen sends $10, says don't know why Jill answered the phone, but I'm glad she did. And she called me back. So thank you guys very, and I guarantee Krusty's already being like, that's why it happened. I said we were live to tape. She knew she was live. Stop it. Anyway, so again, if anyone else wants to donate, the link is at the top for Turtle Chat. Write whatever you message. I'll read it out loud to the class, and you can cash at me $1 Uncle Turtle Boy as well. Why don't we do a little where are you repping right now? Let us know in the comments right now. Where are you watching the Turtle Boy live show from tonight? Go ahead. I'm going to read as many of these as I can. Back in the day, I used to be able to read all of these. But we'll see how many I can get through tonight. Let's see. Award-winning loser. Okay. Plymouth, Winthrop, Raynham's in the house. Another Plymouth, Lowell, Clinton, Stoughton, Mashpee, Quincy, Northbridge, Colerain, Canton, Altoona, Pennsylvania, Mendon, Northbridge, Taunton, Lowell, Foxborough, Canton, New Bedford, Taunton, Dartmouth's in the house, Portsmouth, Rhode Island, Worcester, Squam Lake, Woburn, Rome, Georgia. Let's see, where are we? Rhode Island, North Carolina, Quaker Hill, Connecticut, Plimpton, Brockton, Murdertown, Fort Lauderdale, Malden, New Braintree, Nashua, Townsend, Berkeley, Mass, Plymouth, Dennisport, Haverhill, Dorchester, Lynn, Keene, New Hampshire, South Yarmouth, Weymouth, Plymouth, Sedalia, Missouri, Abington, Avon, Colorado, Charlestown, Bonita Springs, Florida, Gloucester, Watertown, 34 Fairview Avenue, Lakewood Ranch, Florida, Norwood, Manchog, Marshfield, Sutton, Foxborough. 11 people watching you from a campground in Meredith, New Hampshire, Canton, Watertown, Bedford, New Hampshire, Scituate, Nashua, Boca, Florida, Pepperell, Wallingford, Carver, Hall, Gloucester, Needham, Franklin, New Bedford, Raynham, Long Island, Newton, Saugus, Norton, Ipswich, East Greenwich, Sarasota, Worcester, Maplesville, Costco, Maine, Franklin, Millis, Plainville, Oxford, Lowell, New York, Pelham, New Hampshire, Preston, Connecticut, Medford, Charlestown, Halifax, the Dirty Woo, Horry County, South Carolina, Easton, Berkeley, Hanover, Turtle Brook Road, Marshfield, Kingston, New Hampshire, Mansfield, Wildwood, New Jersey, New Bedford, Northbridge. Okay, if I missed you, I missed you. I can't get through all of them. There's too fucking many. I used to be able to get through all these. The crowd's too big. I got as many as I can. Over on Rumble, I'm going to give props to the Rumble people. Sterling, Massachusetts, Wellesley, Canton, Rhode Island, Foxborough, My Kitchen, Linfield, Medford, Dedham, Abington, Big Flats, New York, Taylorsville, Utah, Adams, Massachusetts. That's the first. And Bridgeton, Maine. Shout out to the 370 people watching on Rumble right now and the 2,700 people watching on YouTube. Okay. Somebody else gave me Helena Rafferty's number. Should we call her? She said she talked to anyone. Okay. Somebody sends. Let's give her a call. She's not going to answer. That's the Canton Police Department. Okay. So, is this it? Oh, I got it. That's it. Oh, okay, I got it. Okay, I got it here. Let me call this one. Give me one sec here. I got the number. We're calling her. West Tisbury, Fort Lauderdale. Okay. Now this is actually a great idea. People are like, bad idea? Oh, you must be new here. You must be new here. That's what we call a great idea. What's the name of Lena's channel? It's pretty good. Somebody go, if anyone wants to plug in the comments, you can.
Hi, you've reached the voicemail of Helena Rafferty, Chief of the Canton Police Department. I can't get your phone call right now, but if you leave your name and number, I'll get right back to you. Thanks.
Hi, Helena. This is Aiden Carney, award-winning journalist from Turtle Boy News, calling you. I assume you're watching my show right now. I had no idea you were such a big fan until you talked about me a lot on your show the other night. But you also said a lot of things about me that were really untrue and unnecessary and, quite frankly, hurtful. I feel like we got off on the wrong foot. I just want to ask you some questions, if you could just give me a call back. I'm just wondering, why did you want to talk to everybody outside instead of just addressing the citizens of Canton directly? Like, you were right there. You weren't even facing them. You said that Jennifer McCabe is being targeted, harassed, and intimidated, and that she's some sort of victim. So my question for you is, are you aware that Jennifer McCabe was being investigated by the FBI, that she has been grand juried on May 4th? And if Jennifer McCabe is indicted, are you at all worried how silly and stupid that your speech is going to look in defense of Jennifer McCabe if, in fact, she was involved in the murder of John O'Keefe, which all of the evidence certainly points to? You tell us to wait till this plays out in court. It has. I'm not sure if you've seen the court filings in April filed by attorney Alan Jackson that showed that Jennifer McCabe Googled how long to die and called at 2:27 in the morning and then deleted it and then called her sister twice. And they picked up the phone and they talked for 7 and 9 seconds at 6:07 and 6:08. And then she deleted that as well. So I'm just wondering if you are aware of that. I know you're obviously a police officer, so you must know how to, you know, solve crimes. And these are things we call evidence. So if you could just give me a call back, I'd love to talk about. You said you'd meet up for coffee. I'd love to meet you for coffee. So give me a call back when you get this. Bye. Okay. Jillian just deleted her Facebook. Oh, she does that all the time. She'll be back. Trust me. She'll be back. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about Helena, shall we? You're a loser. Easy, pussycat. Okay. All right. So let's listen to this.
The language change suggested would be to alter members should treat each other with respect to members should treat all people with respect. I just wanted to say that I totally, totally agree with this thought process, especially in these days. People in positions such as mine and that of elected officials should be held to a higher standard. That is why I'm proposing it be adopted by every town board and every elected official.
Oh, yeah.
It's hypocritical to solely make members of the select board adhere to such a rule when we have a current.
So she's basically like, why are you picking on Chris Albert? Why is, because there people are mad that Chris Albert's calling people whores and accusing them of sucking my dick. And I mean, that's all Jill Daniels said. Why is it always sexual with these people? Why is it all like, why is that their first thing? Is Karen Reed's a hooah? You just want to bang her. That's not why I'm doing this. You think that's why I'm doing this? Like, nah, were you crazy? Like that's even on Karen Reed's mind right now. Like, what's, why is that your first thought? Perverts. Perverts. I mean, that's all you can do. Like, and that's what they've done. They've accused Higgins now of banging her. That's the new thing because they don't trust Higgins anymore. They've Tom Beatty, they said the same thing. It's like anybody they don't like, they just accuse of having sex with Karen Reed. It's like, it's all they got because they're the mean girls. These are the mean kids from high school grown up. And people are like, maybe people like elected officials shouldn't be assholes. And then Helene is like, why are you picking on Chris Albert when you should be picking on, let's see, who should be picking on?
Elected planning board member.
A planning board member.
Actively participated in an event that made residents of our community feel disrespected, targeted, and intimidated.
Oh, so somebody on the planning board was in the rolling rally. So they're taking surveillance pictures of people who were at the rolling rally, and the cops were hiding, obviously, and taking pictures of us and taking note of who was there. It's like that person, and they just want, they don't care about me. They want to know who in Canton, who from Canton was there, so that they can continue to do what they've always done, bully you, use their power to bully you. How dare you go to a peaceful event where you bully and target people by what? By what? What do we do? And then who else?
An event that I believe under statute
268-13A
could most possibly be deemed a criminal act.
That's because you're stupid. Now, she was going around handing out things to people at this meeting of 268-38 whatever E. It's basically says that it's in, like, I looked it up here. And by the way, these are Julie Nagel's really intimidated neighbors. They seem so upset, guys. Look at these poor people. They really couldn't stand that we were in their neighborhood calling out their neighbors. By the way, it says that whoever with the intent of interfering with, obstructing, or impeding the administration of justice. We weren't doing that. Like, how are we getting in the way of justice? We weren't impeding the administration of justice. Like, at no point were we like, hey, Jennifer McCabe, you better not testify. That would be one thing. If you were like, you better not fucking testify. We're like, Jennifer McCabe, we got some questions for you. We want you to testify. We want you to talk. Please explain why you Googled how long did I uncold. That's all. Why'd you do that, Jen? We're doing the opposite of that. With the intent or influencing any witness. No, we don't want to influence. We just have questions. So like for the chief of police to be this stupid and ignorant of what the law was, first of all, you knew what we were doing. We announced we were coming. Why'd you let us do it if it's against the law? Why are you now saying it's against the law? And guess what, Helena Rafferty? We're going to do it again. And you know what you're going to do about it? Nothing. You're going to do nothing about that. I fucking dare you to arrest me, Helena. I dare you. I dare you to put me in cuffs. I double dare you. Because that, oh, the content that will come out of that, I will gladly take a charge for whatever bullshit you want to fake charge me on. Try it. Oh, make me a martyr. I dare you. I dare you. Let's dance. Let's dance. Anyway, so there's that. So she obviously is stupid. What did she say in that video? One more thing.
Additionally, we have an elected library trustee.
Oh, the library trustee.
As of noon today, was still listed as a co-administrator on a social site that is allowing residents of our community to also be disrespected.
So that's not even the John and Justice O'Keefe. She's talking about a guy named George Como, the brother of John, I believe, who runs, they kind of co-run the Canton Confidential page, which only, it's like a small page with like a few thousand people. And I think it's like the alternative to the other main Canton page. You know how Facebook works. Somebody starts a townie group, some asshole becomes the administrator of it. It becomes lame. And then there's always the offshoot one. Every town is like this. And Canton's got Canton Confidential, like the other one. It's like the Boston Herald Facebook group of Canton Facebook groups. And I guess some guy named George is the, I guess he's just an admin on it, but he's, I think he's a lawyer too. So it's like, you're going to fuck with a, like, do you realize what you're doing right now? You're attempting to, in like, what did he do wrong? He didn't people are being bullied on Canton Confidential. Even if they were, as long as he's not the one doing it, who gives a shit? Or even if he is the one doing it, who gives a shit? That's how freedom works, stupid. You can say whatever you want on the internet. It's free speech. You're allowed to have opinions. Just because you're picking on poor Jennifer McCabe doesn't mean you're not free.
Dehumanized with innuendos.
Oh no.
Falsehoods,
oh no.
Half-truths and bullying comments.
Imagine that. You allowed half-truths. How dare you? You can only allow full-truths. You're not allowed. If you're an admin on a Facebook page, little do you know, it's against the law for you not to allow, for only allow the half-truth. You got to allow the whole truth and nothing but the truth.
Comments, I might add,
ooh,
that if in, were made or in a school environment, would and should have every resident in this town in an uproar.
But it's not made in the school environment. These are adults. And how would comments like Jill Daniels, the one, what kind of, how would those go over in school? You loser. Fucking loser. Easy, pussycat. Okay. Let's play the next video of her here. What's this one?
This case thus far, I use the word sensational.
Ooh, sensational.
When you Google that word, the first definition to pop up is causing great interest. Ironically, the example used in
Give us
life is a sensational murder trial. My statement expressly asked for people to sit back and wait for all sides to be presented. How Aidan Kearney, aka Turtle Boy, manipulated my message was certainly not how it was intended. However,
as
with many things in this case thus far, Aidan Kearney has shown that his perception is not the reality of the situation. And here's a few examples. Aidan Kearney falsely reported that one of my children dates the daughter of Jennifer McCabe.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Who cares? I don't even remember saying that. It's like, I've said a lot of things. I've reported a lot of things. We're doing a whole murder thing here. Can we stick to that? Nobody gives a shit who your kid's hanging out with or dating. If I said that and it's not true, my bad. I hereby retract it. I don't give a fuck what kids are fucking what kids in your town. I don't care. That's not my primary concern. But you focus on that in order to deflect from the things that actually matter. You fraud. You fraud. No one cares how your stupid kids are hanging out with. But I don't believe you either. I also don't believe you. This sounds very personal with Jen, like you're good friends with her. You know, there's something that doesn't sound right there.
My children have never, ever met any of the McCabe children.
Oh, I find that hard to believe.
Responsible journalists would have fact-checked that.
Ooh, I'm not responsible.
It's such easy information to confirm. And still, to my knowledge, that has not been retracted.
Okay.
Nowhere has Aidan Kearney stated, hey, folks, mea culpa.
Well, like nobody ever told me it wasn't true. If I made a mistake, feel free to contact me and tell me that. And I'll take it out because I really don't give a shit. Nobody cares about that part. I don't even remember saying that. If I said it, show me the blog where I wrote that. I'll gladly take that part out. No problem.
Why? Perhaps because it would bring into question the veracity of as many other allegations.
I picture that.
Theories.
Like pick that. What she's saying there is like, he's lying about this, what else is he lying about? No one's thinking that. Nobody gives a shit. Like, everything he's saying must be a lie because my kid isn't fucking Jennifer McCabe's kid. This is the chief of police. Imagine your town is run by someone this stupid. Your police force is run by someone this stupid. Oh, must be horrible. I feel so bad for the people of Canton. Imagine going, this is your police chief. This is so, I live in a real town. We have like a good police chief here. He's like well-liked. His wife's going to be my kid's third grade teacher, hopefully. She really wants her. If you're out there, Mrs. Sherblom, my daughter wants you for third grade next year. So if you could hook her up, that'd be cool. Just saying. But this town is like a joke. God damn.
Aidan Kearney has also insinuated the slanderous allegation that I had an inappropriate relationship with Chief Burke.
For fuck's sake.
And as a result, he appointed me to my current position. Notwithstanding the fact that Kenny Berkowitz is not the appointing of...
Time out. If you're trying to prove to the world that like you don't have this like lovey-dovey personal relationship with the guy, maybe don't call him Kenny Berkowitz. Like maybe like former Chief Berkowitz. How about that? Kenny. Or Ken. Ken will do. Kenny. Thank you with the guys. It's all about her. She's making this all about her. Just like a chick. Just saying. Like it's all about her. Oh, nobody gives a fuck. Nobody, I don't care if you bang Berkowitz. I don't care if you bang Kenny. I'm like you guys. I'm not obsessed with that stuff. If I made a light-handed comment about it, it is what it is. I don't actually know as a fact you're banging Berkowitz. Some people have rumored that, but I'm not focusing on that, okay? For the record, I don't care if you're banging Berkowitz at all. I don't know if you are. Good for you if you are. It doesn't matter to me. And I don't think that that's how you got your job at all. I don't think you pulled the Genduso. I think you got your job because you're a hack. I think and you're willing to cover shit up. That's how you got your job. Not because of the dick you sucked. I don't think that at all. I think it's because of what a useless stooge you are, because that's who seems to rise to power in Canton.
Authority for this town. I can only hope that such a statement outrages every woman in this community.
Yeah, the women are so mad.
Against these abhorrent, defamatory stereotypes.
Oh, God, she's appealing to women like, ladies, can we get together? I am woman, hear me roar. This massage therapist, misogynist therapist, turtle boy, he's being so mean to women. He's putting our sisters, can we come together and fight back against this massage therapist? Nobody's buying it, dear. No one's buying it. You're not going to, like, the women can't like me. I hate to break it to you. They don't think I'm a massage therapist. So relax with that stuff. Not working.
Decades. In the days leading up to his rolling rally, Aidan Cairn reported to everyone that Jennifer McCabe had fled to Maine to avoid his event.
She did.
Again, he was disingenuous. Jennifer McCabe was in fact home when he and 75 to 80 people in 40 to 50 cars pulled up in front of her home with a bullhorn.
How do you know that? You don't, your kids have never met her kids. You barely know this woman, but you know that she was there that day. First of all, we got pictures of Bitch Tits McCabe the day before at a gunkwit, letting those things hang out in the sun. And they must have rushed back. They really didn't want to miss this rolling rally, did they? They must have rushed back. How do you know that? Did she call the, are you friends with her? Or did she call the police station? How do you know she was home when it happened? And if she called the police, why didn't you respond? Where were you that day? Like I said the other day, where were you? You're so concerned. All these people pay tax dollars to you for your salary to be useless. And, you know, you got this convoy of people coming to town, clogging up the roads. It was literally like parking lot everywhere in Canton that day. And where were you to direct traffic, to make sure that people could get from point A to point B, to make sure people didn't have lawns trampled on? Like, where were you? Where were your officers? I guarantee a roll call the day you discussed this rolling rally. How could you not? And your orders to your officers were, don't be seen. Stand down. Don't go anywhere near them, including when they come to the police station. We didn't see a single cop at the police station.
She was inside with her husband and two of her four children.
How do you know that?
This group of both residents and strangers converge on her home.
Oh, no.
Can you imagine the terror she must have felt for the safety of her children?
Can you imagine the terror that John O'Keefe felt when he walked into 34 Fairview Road and he started being attacked and beaten by a group of thugs and bit by a dog? Can you imagine the terror that he felt? Can you imagine the terror that Karen Reed felt when she came and she found her boyfriend in that condition? Can you imagine that? And she tried doing CPR to him. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine the terror that Karen Reed has felt for the last 18 months, facing life in prison? And you want us to give a fuck about Jennifer McCabe? Go fuck yourself, you useless stooge. Fuck you and fuck Jennifer McCabe. I hope you all burn in hell. You're useless, horrible, vindictive, and you're going down. You've been exposed, and it's only going to get worse from here. Fuck Jennifer McCabe's feelings. Fuck her fake fearing that's already been litigated by a judge that she's not actually in fear. Fuck you. Sorry for the French there, but I mean, let's not beat around the bush. That's what these people need to hear.
Based on the state of the world today.
Oh, the state of the world today.
Again,
yeah.
This is a witness in a case. Additionally,
what did she witness?
I know it's been circulated that John O'Keefe had conversations with Kent police detectives related to drug activity in that neighborhood. Well, I'm here to confirm that. He absolutely did. He reached out to the detective unit directly. However, none. And let me repeat that, none. of his well-documented correspondence with us included anyone alleged by Aidan Kearney to be involved in this case.
I didn't allege anything like
that. The point I'm trying to underscore.
You're so right about that, Willie. Like, she thought this speech was a good idea. She thought this was good. She thought this was good. Oh, oh my God, there he is. There's Bigfoot. Look at those things. Those can get milked. Again, this was like the most peaceful rally. Like, this is the rolling rally. Look at all those horrible people. Just like, what do we do? First of all, why is there no like... bunch of middle-aged people. Oh my God. Like, look at the... Oh no. Those guys are gonna... Those are some killers right there. Look how dangerous those people are. Oh no. Oh my gosh. Look at... Oh no. Oh! How did the tatted kitten ever survive? Look at the... Oh, Jennifer McCabe was just... Those women are bloodthirsty. Oh dear. Oh no. Oh, Jesus Christ. Jennifer McCabe's having flat... Oh, look at that. Oh my God. Oh my God. It's so scary. It's so scary. Look, oh, it's the greatest hits. What is this? Look at this. It's, oh no. Oh no. Jennifer's fearing, guys. She's fearing. Look at this. Oh, it's so scary. So scary. Oh, this is my favorite Dylan song ever, by the way. I could never get tired of this song, ever.
Like a rolling stone. Can you? You used to.
Hi. Now you don't talk so loud.
Oh, look, it's horrible. Don't. Look at this traffic.
Like a complete unknown, like a rolling stone.
Oh yeah, it's so horrible. It's so horrible. Okay. Anyway, juice with it. All right. So it's so scary. I hope Jennifer survived the horror of all that. Oh, she wasn't done.
Yesterday, I received an email from a concerned citizen related to and I quote, horrendous threatening posts on this site.
Oh, horrendous.
Asking me to address the issue.
Oh no.
She is worried about how it may incite people to act moving forward.
Hey, stop it.
As crystal stop clear it. As possible to, as I continue with my comments to our residents, I embrace the fact that we live in a country where people can have different viewpoints.
Oh,
I respect everyone's right to voice those viewpoints. The First Amendment. Sorry. I can appreciate that some people have questions on the O'Keefe case based on the limited information they have seen thus far. However, what I cannot accept is witnesses. Let me repeat that.
Witnesses.
These are residents who have not been charged with any crimes, being bullied in their homes, at their children's games, or on vacation, all under the guise of the...
First of all, like, witnesses being bullied at their kids' games? I didn't bully anyone, first of all. And the game was in Billericus. It's not even in your jurisdiction. And the other one was in Gunkwit and happened on the internet. We posted pictures of them. It was a fact. They were there. That's not bullying. They also killed someone. So there's that. And what did she say here? The guise of the First Amendment?
Under the guise of the First Amendment.
No, it's not under the guise of the First Amendment. It's under the First Amendment. The word under the guise means like you're using that, but you have ulterior motives. We don't. We want to exercise the First Amendment rights. It's literally what we're doing. Under the guise. No, not under the guise of the First Amendment. Just under the First Amendment. How about that?
This is a really slippery slope that, if allowed to continue, will cause a rapid decline in the amount of people who would ever step forward.
Allowed to continue. Allowed? This, oh, King George, you're allowing us? You're allowing us to express our First Amendment rights? Whenever you hear the people use the word slippery slope like that, it means they're attempting to stop something. They're like, no, we need to stop this free speech thing because it's a slippery slope. Nope. No slippery slope. You can say whatever you want. It's a free country. You don't like it, fuck off. Move to a country that's not free.
To be a witness in a case. And quite possibly the slow erosion of the criminal justice system.
Oh, yeah. We're really eroding it. Oh, yeah.
Conversely, by the way, as like, one of the...
Because the criminal justice system is working out swell in the Karen Reed case. Things are going fine. If that's how the criminal justice system works, it needs shaking up. And I'm happy to do it. I mean, these people act like they don't live in a country found by revolutionaries who are going around tarring and feathering people. Like, hello? Like everybody we worship, George Washington and Thomas Jefferson, like they led a pretty violent insurrection against the government and then they overthrew them. I'm not saying that's gonna, we're not there yet. Trust me. We're just posting memes and shit and bitch tits. Like that's, you'll be okay. We're not tarring and feathering anyone.
The judicial system, I'm sorry. Conversely, as one of the many people responsible for the safety and well-being of people in this community, I will not tolerate.
You did tolerate. You did. You did tolerate.
Participating.
Oh, you won't.
In actions that place those on the other side of this debate in fear.
Oh yeah, she's talking about the egg lady. Yeah, but so why haven't you arrested egg lady yet then? Yeah, because she's still out there. This
patient. Well, the examples that I put forth as well is the same one I was trying to make in my initial statement. Take information in and verify it.
Oh yeah.
Be patient while all aspects of the case unfold. This system is painfully slow, and it should be, as the gravity of its process holds the liberty of someone in its midst.
Yeah, it should be. You're right.
Follow the actual trial. Listen to all of the information.
We have been.
Let the courtroom be the forum where both sides get to present their case in full. Then make your own informed decision, whatever that's going to be. I know that mistrust for the
Kansas
Department has taken root around this case.
Yes, it has.
Based on the feedback that I and offices have received, I'm not sure that it is nearly as widespread as portrayed by one of the speakers at the last meeting. However, I do acknowledge that it is there, and I hear you. I believe the first step in bridging that trust gap is effective and healthy communication. I'm also open to discussing ideas that residents believe will help build that fractured trust amongst those experiencing it.
Like, what's that?
So let me reiterate. I am willing to meet with any Canton resident one-on-one wherever in town you would feel most comfortable so that we can have a dialogue where you can ask questions and you can get a sense of who I am and what I stand for as the leader of the Canton Police Department. And finally, as I close.
Okay. So, yeah, not sure about any of that. Okay. So is that the end of her stupid speech? Hold on one sec. I got to get something more. I got to go get a drink of water real quick. I'm just going to play a video while I do that. Hold on. I will be right back. Just listen to this audio while I'm gone. 2 seconds, I promise.
Cigarettes. Like, if you would, at first you would steal them, I would punish her for stealing them. And then I decided that I didn't want the alternative happening, so I would leave them out. I knew she was stealing them, and then I said, well, I don't really want to teach her to fucking steal, so I would tell her, you have to. At first I attached a chore to it, and then I said, this poor lady asked me, and there are certain times that I'll say no, because I just know that when she wakes up in the morning and goes, can I have a cigarette before school? Like, no, you can't get into that habit, because this is a hard enough one to break. When you start fucking habitually smoking at certain times and getting into those rituals, it's even fucking harder. I don't know what's going to happen. Like I said, I know the kids smoke weed. Like, you know, not a big fucking deal to me anymore. I have harder lines, you know, bigger issues. Last summer, I started to get a boyfriend at the time. I let the boyfriend sleep over the house, and I provided them with condoms. Like, you know. I was like, what's the alternative, really? Yeah.
She'd go out and do it anyway.
Right. Like, in a much more unsafe place. And like, you know, I'm not that much older than her. I remember when I was 18. It's not like I don't understand this shit to a certain degree. You just where they can hang out safely. I have rules that I feel like are pretty fucking, I mean, they're pretty lax. Like, I know that they smoke pot and I don't give them a hard time. I don't allow drinking or hard drugs in my house. That's it. And like, I will call the police if I find, and they know them. Like, I feed them, I cook for them and I feed them. And I'll drive them around. Like, you know, that's like, I'm not sitting there fucking doing arts and crafts with them all the time. And like, you know, they deal with, you know, me screaming on the internet sometimes or, you know, I shouldn't even say that. Like, I don't, Andy is not a fucking batterer, like by any stretch of the imagination. He's definitely put hands on me once or twice in the last 10 years. He's got fucking problems, but like.
Okay. Okay, so that person right there, that's the official spokesperson, actually, for the McCabe's and Alberts right there. That's, okay, teach their own. Okay, but anyway, I'm back. I got my drink of water there. So I think we're done with Helena Rafferty. I guess last thing we'll talk about, actually, is that that group there, the support group. Let's talk about the support group. We called some of these people earlier. Yeah, we didn't even get to the Court TV lady. Maybe we could do, all right, we'll do that. We'll do this and then we'll do that. We're running out. Okay, we're getting late here. All right, got a couple turtle chats too to jump through here. Lori sends $25, says lawn sign up. They were nice enough to sell before the planned time. Amazing people. Thank you very much, Lori. Jackson's $5 says, Haas long until Jen McCabe and the rest of her white trash clan are behind bars. Jen is an animal. As is anyone associated with her. Haas long until the truth comes out. Call the children of any of them involved. Not calling any children, but thank you very much. Hi. Annette sends 25, says, hi, Annette again for the fourth time. I just got on, so I have no idea what you talked about so far. Are they going to be able to test John's clothes to see if it shows that the dog attacked him? Yes, they are. Also, what's the hearing going to be about on the 15th? We don't know. One more thing. How do I see that video from the board meeting from the other night? It's on the blog, so you can just check that out. I think it's like part 96. Lauren Tanzi sends $10, says, I'm speechless, and that's hard to do. Keep up the amazing content, and thank you for giving people the news we want. You never miss, sir. And someone check on Jill. She may have had an aneurysm. I know, dude. I know. Something happened there. That was an episode of all episodes. Do we have any cash apps here that I'm missing? Yep. Dr. Nips. We're on the Nips thing again. Sends $5 and says, for your areolas are a perfect match to your nips. Okay. Mary sends $15, says, for Colin left before John got there. Little sub. No, they admit Colin was there. They just claim that he left before he got there. So again, I showed you guys earlier, this is undeniable. Like, for just to kill, nip this in the bud, this is what the Krusty Panties has been telling them. And again, she doesn't get to be part of the narrative, but I'm only bringing it up because she is their official spokesperson. Actually, yeah, right here. Colin Albert, I'm just going to highlight this. No, don't want that one. Want the straight line one. Give me that one. Colin Albert, according to Nicole and Brian Albert's testimony before the grand jury, Colin Albert was also present for at least part of the party. Okay. We know that Brian Albert did not get back there to the house. Brian Albert closed down the waterfall bar with John O'Keefe and Karen Reed. They all left at around 12, 10 or something like that. And then they got there at the earliest 12:15. They're saying that Colin left at 12:10. But Brian Albert and Nicole Albert themselves say when they got there, Colin was there. So first of all, the whole thing about Colin was gone is debunked immediately by this. Secondly, are you telling us that Colin Albert, who obviously is, you know, likes to party and have a good time, was out drinking on a Friday night at his uncle's house? And then his uncle gets there and they come back sauced up And he, Colin's like, you know what? I'm going to go home because I'm responsible. I'm a responsible 18-year-old. I'm going to get the fuck out of here. It's past my bedtime. That's what you want us to believe. Okay, sure. Again, show me the evidence of that. And we'll take the blogs down. Not a problem, Jill. I got you. I got you because I look for the truth. I look for the truth. That's what I'm all about. So let's just jump through this stupid group here. Let's talk about this group, shall we? The secret group. And this is so funny. So that individual I just played for you, talking about throwing condoms at her kids, and that a lot of you don't know who she is, and that's understandable. She's nobody. She's just a troll who won't go away, and she's obsessed with yours truly and wants to become part of the narrative of the story. So she has become like kind of like the official spokesperson for these losers. And because no one else will defend them. And like, this is the kind of stuff she says about my kid, who is 8, by the way. And so she tried to send her, she sent her kid after me. Like, she has a 16-year-old runaway kid, truant, who sent some really horrible things to me about my kids, who at the time were 5 and 7. They're 6 and 8 now. And this is what she said about her in a tweet about, she said that, I recall my daughter saying that Eden's poor abused daughter will grow up to be promiscuous. Word is she's already started. Yeah, my daughter's 8. Okay, she's 8. I mean, what kind of demented, who says something like that's, you have some serious issues. Anyway, this is what the group leader has also posted, that she got, so Boston Magazine, so there's a support group called Support McCabe's, Alberts, and O'Keefe's. Because at this point, I mean, it's like, who really is the O'Keefe's? It's like, okay, Peg O'Keefe, I'm supposed to feel sorry for her. I guess I do. But also, like, she's kind of like, I don't at the same time. Like, sorry. I just don't feel bad for her because she just looked like, I'm not going to boo her. I've specifically not attacked her. But I think she's just kind of an evil person, to be perfectly honest with you. I see evil in her. Like, I just, like, who doesn't care about their kid enough to want to know the truth about what happened to him? Like, if somebody did this to me and all this evidence is out there about people Googling shit at 227 and shit like that, my mom would be looking for answers, demanding answers. Peg O'Keefe is not doing that, which really says a lot about her. Oh, we're supposed to be nice to her. Okay. We're past that. Not the grieving process is over. The O'Keefe's are now on the harassing process, harassing small businesses. So we're done with that. So anyway, this might be the person who left the review, but she certainly is. She's their spokesperson. And so she forms this group. She wants to insert herself into this. So she's like, I'm going to defend you guys when no one will. I'm going to defend the indefensible. It makes this post about, I know several people have been contacted by Gretchen of Boston Magazine. Gretchen has contacted me and everyone involved in this. And she's doing a story on this. And she came and interviewed me. And I think she came to the Rolling Rally to observe it. Because she's a reporter and that's what she's doing. And I think they saw her there and were like, she's evil. They were giving her looks and shit like that. Like, so they're saying that, oh, I have as well. You have been contacted. I find that hard to believe. I bet you contacted her and have maintained communication with her. I'm really trying to convince her that the story isn't the ridiculous and cruel fantasy story that the defense is spreading for Karen Reed, but instead the staggering toll it's taking on so many innocent and grieving human beings. I'm sure you're trying to convince her of that. Probably not going to work out that way because, you know, Gretchen's not stupid. I'm still a little wary of her intentions. Her intentions is to tell the truth. If I'm being honest, I'm thoroughly disgusted with the media at large in this case. Yeah. Don't you hate the media for telling the truth? But at least outwardly, she seems to agree with me. So I'm cautiously optimistic. I just wish the public understood better what is really going on here and remembered that at the center of this, there's an actual victim, and it's not Karen Reed. It is John O'Keefe and now his friends and family as well. Yeah, it is John O'Keefe. And the people who killed him are in this group. So there's that. And one of the admins is this woman, Lisa Crisilio. There's Jill Daniels. And then there's Tim Albert's Fupa hanging out there. So Lisa Crisilio is either, I don't know if she's the baby mama for Tim's kids or just the girlfriend or what, but they live in that house across the street where the pool got filled in. And she even admits that this is my 45-year-old fiberglass pool that in the last 3 to 5 years, we had to keep fixing and filling with water and blah, 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 blah. It wasn't cheap. Okay. Then she goes, I was a procrastinator who didn't pick a company to take it until October. By the way, the company they picked were themselves. They took the pool down. So that's not what you weren't a procrastinator. You got the pool filled in a week after you guys got named in court. So what's in that pool? I'm just wondering. Which we all know now stupidly coincided with the court date. I had no clue was even, of course, you had no clue. Totally no clue. Okay. Then again, here they are. Did it himself, by the way. They did it themselves. Oh, and this one. So that she's going to get him an attorney. So I put a call into an attorney I've worked with in the past in civil court. What attorney is that? I've missed that because civil court, who have you sued? Who have you ever sued before? What? And you put a call in. Okay, what does that mean? To feel out any options, costs, associated to put a damper on the ongoing harassment defamation. Again, if you guys are listening to Jill Daniels and stuff, just know this. I know you don't like me and all, but this individual here has been talking lawsuits against me for years. Years. And it never happens. Like, she talks about it all the time. I know lawyers and I'm calling this person. So if you're putting your faith in this person, it's not going to end the way you think it's going to end. I don't want to ruin the ending for you. But I wouldn't put all your eggs in one basket. It's probably Gaffney. Like, it's probably Gaffney or Richard N. Volva, or somebody like that, okay? I'd like someone to step in and deal with the cops, media, and Aiden for all parties being victimized to try and reduce the things like home visits from strangers. Nope, yeah, you can't do that. That's the First Amendment. Crazy defamatory statements? No, they're all true. Public destruction and borderline stalking? Yeah, borderline stalking isn't a thing. And by the way, this individual had court on Friday for violation of a harassment prevention order. So she knows a thing or two about stalking. Also, I think I'm going to see her on Wednesday because I have court in the Gianetti Hall of Justice in West Roxbury on Wednesday with her baby daddy who pulled a knife on her daughter and assaulted me on the courthouse steps in West Roxbury in January when I was covering her case. So I'll be in court, and as fate would have it, so will she, because I heard that her restraining order renewal is up and she has court that same day. So fancy that. And you know who else has court in that same day, in that same courtroom, in the Hall of Justice? Guess who? That would be Boston City Councilor Kendra Lara. We got three douchebags going once. That's like a Turtle Boy wet dream right there. Oh, that's why you need to hit that notification bell for the impromptu lives. Ho, ho, ho. Wednesday is going to be a doozy. Yikes, yikes, yikes. So she says that, I don't know what will come of it, but I do know some people who may at least know some people. No, you don't. You definitely don't. And nothing's going to come of it. Trying to find something contingency based pro bono. Yeah. You're not going to find a lawyer to work for free, dear. You're going to have to pay. And even then you're going to lose. So there's that. And you're dealing with broke people here. So it's just like, oh, it's so good. She just wants to feel part of the team, wants to feel accepted. Like, we love you. We are with you. McCabe's, Alberts, O'Keefe's, Roberts, and Proctor's. Why are Proctor's on there? Like, why are the Proctor's in this group? I thought the Proctor's didn't know these people. Now they're in a support group together. That's interesting. Very interesting. These people hand, they're handing the defense this case, man. And by the way, Jen McCabe, this is interesting, talks in this group because she doesn't post anywhere. And somebody posted her, like, showing her heart rate data as if that proves that actually she didn't do it. Thank you for sharing. Just shows how much the defense is once again lying. That's all you got, Jen? Oh. And this guy, Sean Hickey, who is, the town homosexual. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but word is that he had a thing for John. That's what they say. I don't really know him. This is not our Sean Hickey. There's two Sean Hickeys, good and bad Sean Hickey. This is bad Sean Hickey. And he's a big anti-Karen person in this group. And, you know, they're shitting on Tom Beatty. Some friend he is for John. Yeah. If you don't get in line, you're not a friend. And now this woman, Liz Galvin, is like, I guess she has law enforcement background. So they know this woman. And this is what they do in this group. They like share. So Liz Galvin, I guess, is a former friend of theirs or something like that. But she's been sharing the crazy stuff where she's like, I don't think he was run over. And so what do? They're like, FYI, clearly someone who a lot of people are Facebook friends with that is with TB. So they're screenshotting all the things that you're saying and posting and messaging and be like, we need to kick her out. John O'Keefe is the victim. Yes, he was. He was stolen from her family and friends. Yes, he is. Karen Reed is going to lie. No, she's not. You can tell the truth. Nothing that she says matters. Nope. Nothing you say matters. Yeah, exactly. They're so mad. They're so mad. Karen Reed's full of shit. He defends rapists, pedos. Yeah. Yeah, they do. Yeah, he like Alan Jackson and David Yenney have defended some shitty people. No doubt. That's their job. And like they're sharing memes like this of Karen. Poor Karen. But like she gives a shit though. Like she gives a shit. How about this? The Lexus. This is their other big thing. Now, this is, they're all accusing me. Karen's brother, Nate, works at a Lexus dealership in Rhode Island. And now they're accusing him of paying me. Like I got a shiny new Lexus in the garage. That's what hard work gets you. And being cheap. I also don't spend a lot of money. So I save. And I'm like, fuck it. I used to get used cars. I don't need to live like that. I can get something nice. I'm going to treat myself. And I did that. And it's fucking awesome. Every time I get in that car, it's like, oh, I'm so glad I did it. It's orgasmic. It never gets old. I love being in the car. I want to sleep in the car. It's fucking awesome. And so best thing I ever did. Now, they're saying that Nathan Reed must have hooked me up, like as if that they can do that, as if the Lexus dealership itself is just going to take one on the chin and do that. Also, spoiler alert, I got it in Northboro. He works in Rhode Island. So I guess when he made a phone call, I'm like, hey, hook my guy up with a free Lexus. Okay. I mean, this is just fantasy world. And by the way, it was, they believe he goes to use. No, it was brand new. It was actually 2023. It's fucking dope. It's so dope. So there's that. Okay. And they're all saying like, oh my God, the Lexus and the admission of receiving a defense document. Would love to know how much he's getting paid. $0, Laura. Laura is the one who is fake crying in that picture in court where Jennifer, she's the fat blonde chick with the boyfriend who cheated on her or the husband who cheated on her. There's some crazy story there where three people got impregnated by John's partner who committed suicide in 2013. There's a crazy story with that too. I think she's one of them. And so she's there with the boyfriend or the husband or somebody now, some cuck. And she's like crying. Justice for JJ. And Jennifer McCabe's rubbing her shoulders. It's like, shut up, you stupid cow. Shut up. And they're like, these are the people we're booing, and rightfully so, because they're trash. They're trash. I proudly boo them, and I will boo them every single time anyone's wearing that stupid pins getting booed on the way into court. And we're not the bad guy for doing that. We're actually the good guys. So there's that. Okay. Yeah, we can moo you instead. How about we moo you instead of booing you? Is that a better solution? When they come in, instead of booing them, we're just going to moo you. Moo! We're going to moo you. Oh, that's glorious. Oh, I love you people. We're going to moo you. They watched her stupid streams and they're like, that was amazing. Imagine watching one of those things. Be like, that was so good. Oh, and she came to my house. So Krusty, during the Canton Rolling Rally, she knew I wasn't going to be here. So she came to my house and she handled it. Apparently, I didn't even know this till a week later. Notice this is all like rained on. It's like all blurry and shit. It was left. We didn't know it was there. I saw this picture later on. I'm like, did she really bring something to my house? She took a picture of my mailbox, which, as you can see, is being held up by rope because I'm at constant war with my plow, the plow guy. I pay every season. I pay to get that thing put back in because I'm not doing it myself. I just have someone else doing it. Fucking get it put in there. And then I look every time it snows, it's just down. And I call the town and I say, what the fuck's going on here? It wasn't us. Yeah, it wasn't us. I'm going to catch him one day. One day I'm going to catch him. But I make do. So I got my bootleg mailbox there. She comes to my house. Didn't someone, yo, she accused me of that, which I didn't do. I've never been there. I don't have any reason I want to go to her. I don't go to the ghetto. Aiden's mailbox is on the ground, held up by a fucking rope. Yes. His soft hands have never touched a hammer before. I'm certain. Ooh, yeah. Less certain about other men's penises, though. Yes, I touch men's penises. Owned. Yes, very much so. And then she's like, this is how I knew a note was left. I left this at his door. Can't wait for the call from Holden PD because he's a prick. So I didn't call Holden Police because I don't care. You don't mean anything for that. And notice she comes when she knows I'm not here because she's afraid of me. Like, why don't you just confront me? Like, what are you afraid of? Why are all these people afraid of confronting me? They hide when I come to town. They hide from me. What are they afraid of? Instead, you want to come after my family. They're not involved. The people I'm going after in an interview and asking questions are involved. They're in the game. Jennifer McCabe. She Googled how long did I call? Sorry, I got some questions. Got some questions for that. Y'all were involved in covering up a murder, so I have some questions. You're going to come after innocent people? She also says she's coming to my daughter's cheerleading competitions and shit. First of all, you're not. You know you're not going to. I dare you. If you do, you're going to look like a fucking lunatic. You're not going to get anything accomplished. And yeah, I mean, that's the thing. It's like people like me, they don't like you. So there's that. So give it a shot. Like she sends this whole thing like, I miss you. I leave this note. There's morons going around town. Okay, yeah, sure you are. She just wants to be their hero. And that's all it comes down to. If anyone sues him, it would end him. They keep saying he's guaranteed to get sued. Oh, I'm still waiting. Still waiting. Then there's this fat broad here, evil looking next to the Fuposaurus egg thrower. She posts. Her name is Michelle Nally. And Lizzie Proctor's posting pictures of Angela O'Donnell saying, our girl Angela, this is the wife of an investigating state trooper. Got this one of her outside our house. And by the way, were those kids selling lemonade? Were they terrorized too? Just wondering. They seem pretty happy. So they're harassing private citizens. Michelle Nally says that the defense team, 12 of them, were eating at my work. Not your average Joe's last night. Now, I was invited out to eat by Karen's parents. I had a thing. I couldn't make it. But they were going to eat somewhere in Foxborough. And so she seems to have her defense team confused with her parents. Like I'm guessing Alan Jackson doesn't eat at places called Not Your Average Joe's. I'm just saying. He doesn't seem like the type. He seems more like a steak guy. And so I highly doubt that. Their whole defense team was there and whatever. Her defense team was probably with Karen. Like Karen was not going to come with us. I don't hang out with Karen, but I'll befriend her parents. Sure. They're not the ones on trial. They managed to tell everyone that this poor girl was framed for murder by all the corrupt cops in Canton and Norfolk County. Needless to say, I spent the day telling the truth about what her lawyer is and how much evidence the prosecution has on her, which is none. No one knew who Turtle Boy was. That's how you know she's lying. Okay. And they're doing all of this to protect protect killers and prosecute a woman who they know is innocent. I mean, that's just evil. They're trying to find stuff about Sean McDonough, Sean on the Gulf. Bad news for you. Sean doesn't give a shit and he's not the type to be intimidated. He's going out. He spent his life going after drug dealers in Bogota. I don't think he's afraid of Canton assholes. And this woman's in the group too. I called her earlier. This is Heather Sullivan. She answered the phone, but she didn't say anything. She is a teacher or an administrative assistant or something at Canton High School. And everybody tells me that she's like gives the jocks, like, you know, makes inappropriate comments to them, gives them all preference. People like Colin and stuff like that. Like that is the, it is seeped into the public schools there. Don't forget the diddler's wife, John Blake's wife also works at Canton High School. Like there is a culture here that permeates all aspects of town, all aspects of town government. So she's in that group. Meg Kennedy, that trashy broad's in that group. There's Heather Sullivan there with Chris Jr., Chicken Parm Charlie himself. I assume that's one of the loser Alberts. Oh, there's Kevin Albert. And I think Kevin Albert's a lot more involved in this than anyone realizes. If you guys listen to the 911 tape, when Chicken Parm Charlie, I thought Chicken Parm Charlie called the cops on me. It was actually Kevin. Kevin did. So he called Kevin and Kevin sent them down there. I wonder about that. So there she is. And by the way, like D&E Pizza survives as a business because they get shit like this. Like they get the contracts, like the Little League, the schools, like they have to buy it off of him. When if they're having an event, they're just going to get it from D&E Pizza. Why? Because Chris Alba runs it. I'm sure they're not the only pizza shop in town. Why don't the other, like, does it go out to bid? I don't know. And they're all worried about like our whole protest and rolling rally. They're like, don't give, you know, the public appearance was a last attempt for them before the gag order hopefully goes in tomorrow. It didn't. It didn't. They lost. They lost. Don't retaliate. Yep. We weren't violent at all. I've just learned that Aiden Carney is supposedly doing an interview with Court TV. Yeah, they tried so hard to get me kicked off Court TV. Oh, and Matt McCabe's sister made an appearance for the first time. She put out all the emails of all the addresses of the producers. And I do think this got to Vinny because he asked me about this stuff, about like harassing witnesses and whatever outside of court. And I was happy to answer it because the truth will set you free. Yeah. Anyway, you guys get the point. Oh, and stupid Carl's in there. Local moron Carl's in there. He's commenting and Jill Daniels is there. They were so mad about the Dateline thing. Oh my God. They lost their shit when they found out Karen was going on Dateline. Oh my God. They're letting her on. That's the thing. These people are all just about suppression. Like they do not want people. I can't wrap my head around the fact that I couldn't let my kids outside today because of this dildo. But he's bringing kids to look at innocent people's houses as a tourist. Look how happy we all look together. This dildo, they're so mad about it. Oh, and Krusty Panties offered to pay them all lunch. No one took her up on it because they don't like you. They don't like you, dear. But yeah, it's just like, this is just, I can't believe that like their whole goal is suppression. And our whole goal is like, let's talk. Let's get all the facts out there. You heard my conversation with Jill today. Like, I'm like, yeah, let's have a conversation. Let's talk about this. Let's talk about the facts. She didn't want to talk about the facts. She just wanted to yell at me. And they just want to silence you. Like, that's their only goal, is to shut you up. They just want to shut you up. Like, why not? Why don't, if you're so innocent, why don't you talk about it? Why don't you talk about it? Explain to me where you're innocent. Colin wasn't there. Okay. Show me that. And I'll be happy to correct the record. Be happy to. Oh, and they took pictures of me going to the waterfall. A gremlin walks into a bar. Yes, he does. Yes, he does. And they're taking pictures of others. Like, oh, like they're watching you. They're watching you. And I'm in their group. So the group has quieted down since I published this blog. And there's that. Now, last thing, read what Deb sent me. Yeah, she's like, got good advice for me. I don't know what to do with this. Let's see. What did she say? I think because I talked about this on Turtle Club. So you should really just join Turtle Club and listen to my rant about this woman. We're not going to this fucking nut job. The expert. Now, I will say this. This is the woman that they brought on to be like the expert. And she does. She's a fucking lunatic. She was the only, they brought her on to be like the contrarian, to be like, actually, I believe Karen Reed did this. And she's a certifiable nut. Go check out the meltdown she's having on Twitter or watch David Yannetti owning her. Like, this was this happened on Twitter. Watch this. So she writes, the public should understand that the defense pays attorneys, the defense attorneys pay bloggers and PR firms to elevate nonsensical defense theories. First of all, they're not nonsensical. Second of all, like, that is blatantly libelous to say that I'm being paid by them. It's completely untrue. And how any attorney could, like, who, she just must be nuts, like nuts. How any attorney could say something like that on record, it's completely untrue, is crazy. She also said that that John O'Keefe was hit in the driveway by Karen, which nobody contends, fell on his butt. Then she backed into him again. That's how his head got hit, not his torso, because he was sitting down on the snow. And then left him there to die. And then the plow guy came in, plowed the driveway, because that's what municipal plowers do. They plow private driveways now. She said they shouldn't, but they do. And then pushed him 20 yards across the lawn where he ended up there. And that's how he got the scratches on his arm. But she said, she's an attorney saying these things. And then David Yannetti responds to this, because she's accusing them of, like, the JFK comment, calling it uneducated, like, uneducated and gullible people swept up in the silliness. The same people who think JFK Jr. is still alive think cops killed O'Keefe to conspire. And this is what's called a ratio, dear, 37-4. Only a boomer doesn't realize that that's embarrassing. And you just embarrassed yourself. And then David says, I'm disappointed in you as a former colleague. They used to work together. We have not paid anyone a dime. He found the story completely on his own reading of our public filings. Also, your theory of the case is nonsense. It is clear you have done no homework and you are just spouting off without understanding the evidence. Shame on you, Wendy. He has the best things. He's like, how dare they? Shame on you, Wendy. It sounds so much more serious coming from him because he's the more, like, straight and narrow of the two attorneys, the less theatrical. So when he says it, it just kind of carries a little more weight. Any truth about the Waltham cheerleaders? What's that? Somebody said something about Waltham cheerleaders and me to her, but I wasn't entirely sure about it. But the Duke lacrosse shit, dude, is crazy. You guys remember Duke lacrosse, that scandal? 15 years ago, three innocent Duke players, lacrosse players, were falsely accused of raping a stripper that they hired. They all, at the time she was allegedly raped, they all had alibis. None were there. They gave her a fucking lineup of there was 47 players on the Duke lacrosse team. One of them was black. He was the only one who did not have to give a DNA sample because she said that she was raped by three white boys. So they all had to have their civil rights violated by handing over DNA samples. And she said that, and they handed her a picture of all of them. And she just got to pick three. So she picked three, said that they raped her. And as it turns out, it was all a bunch of fantastic lies. There's a good 30 for 30 on it. And they, like, there was nationwide protests and all. Like, it was all a lie. And one of the people who was the worst offender was Wendy Murphy, attorney Wendy Murphy. And so it's just amazing that this woman is still allowed on TV. Do you guys remember the Duke lacrosse thing? Like, that was one of the worst things I've ever seen. Like, what happened to those poor kids? And they were vindicated eventually, but it's like, it's very similar to Karen. It's just like, what? You want us to believe this? Like, and then people believed it. So this is her. Like, I found this clip of her. We're back and watch this.
And many believe. It seemed everyone had an opinion, and many believed the alleged victim.
They've gotten away with a lot for a very long time. Why not go home and celebrate? You don't think you're going to get in trouble?
Some of them.
They've gotten away. That's her. They've gotten away with a lot for a very long time. Why not go home and celebrate? They're not getting in trouble. Those kids were completely innocent. Now, you would think you would be embarrassed about this. Like, why is Court TV? She's been on CNN since then, MSNBC. Why is Court TV platforming this complete jagoff? Like, why? Like, the shame on them. Hopefully, they never. This woman should be banished. based solely on the Duke lacrosse shit. Never mind the outrageous shit she's saying about Cameron Reed right now, the defamatory thing she's saying about me, about the defense team. And this is like she's still saying, these are some actual quotes from her about Duke lacrosse. Let me read them. She's saying about those players, to suggest that they were well-behaved, Hitler never beat his wife either. So what? She said that on TV, on CNN, she said that. I have never, ever met a false rape claim. My own statistics speak the truth. No one ever lies about rape. I bet one or more of the player was, you know, molested or something as a child. And in just like with Morrissey, the district attorney in this case withheld exculpatory evidence that he knew would clear these boys. And he ended up being disbarred and charged. And she said, Mike Nifong, the DA, should be rewarded for respecting the defendant's rights by not leaking the type of evidence that could help him personally respond to criticism. What does that even mean? So she says crazy. And today, in the last 24 hours, if you go on Twitter, I'll read a tweet that she sent today. Oh my God. I'll bring up my Twitter right now. This is how we'll end it. I mean, it's just like, how is somebody like this brought on TV as an expert for anything? Anything. This is a loser. All right. So this is what she says about Duke lacrosse today. She's still like everyone. The Duke lacrosse thing has gone down in history as one of the greatest hoaxes and horrible things to do to innocent people ever. Everybody agrees with that now. But Wendy is still saying stuff like this. The victim in the Duke case, Crystal Mangum, who, by the way, for the last 10 years, has been incarcerated for murder. She's in jail the rest of her life because she murdered someone. And she's one of the greatest liars of all time. Proven. The victim in the Duke case was offered $2 million to recant. I was asked to represent her. No, you weren't. I said I don't facilitate money for lies. So she's basically just throwing out there, oh yeah, the only reason those kids got off is because the woman accepted a $2 million bribe to make it go away. She just makes that up. She just throws it out there. She also said that they raped them with the broom, which literally no one said. She just says shit like this. The broomstick. What? Oh my God. Oh, I didn't say she took the bribe. I have no idea if she did. Well, then why did she recant then? Ask her lawyer. Oh, I assure you the families of the players are not pleased that you are opening this can of worms. Yeah, I'm sure the Duke lacrosse players are really upset with me. This is insane. And this is what she wrote. By the way, look at this. 48 responses. One like. Who's the like, Troll Homeo? Who is it? Sharon Kirk. Whoever that is. How could cops kill John O'Keefe after Cameron Reed left the scene, then frame Reed by going to her house in a blizzard, breaking her taillight, and coming back to the crime scene to plant pieces of it in the driveway? They didn't go to her house. They went to her parents' house, towed it to the Canton Police Department, and did it that way. That's what, like, this, what? Like, use your damn head. It's just like, oh my God. I cannot believe this person is real. Like, I'm like, this is a joke, right? No, this person gets invited on TV a lot. They teach, they're an adjunct professor at the New England School of Law, and they write for the Boston Herald. Like, that needs to end. If you want to be taken seriously, you cannot have this lunatic on. And that's what she is. She's a fucking lunatic. All right, let's end the show. Read a couple of turtle chats here. J Jackie F sends $10, says, Callie, get ready to wear that wig at Christmas, baby. There you go, Callie. And then do we have any cash apps? I don't want to miss anything. Okay. All right. Why don't we do a little Ask Turtle Boy? Do you guys have any questions? Fire away. I could talk about this shit all night, man. Let me tell you. What a show this was, huh? It's freaking almost midnight. There's 2,200 people on YouTube and 300 more people on Rumble. Does Jill Daniels have a job? That's a great question. I don't know. I really don't know. Man, like, how could you? What company hires that woman? Dude, I can't wait to break down the Jill Daniels tape. That was that not the wildest? What a show this was tonight, huh? What a show. I know I do need to do another Canton freestyle. You're right. The next Canton selectman meeting, I would assume is it every 2 weeks they have it? I don't even know. Did Jill say no? She's like, John was never in the house. Yeah, okay. Well, the data says otherwise. The phone data says otherwise. She was a nanny? Wow. Did any other TV programs contact you for interviews? No, but I have something much bigger than that in the works. It's not a TV program. Let's just put it that way. We'll leave it at that. We'll leave it at that. What about Higgins? I addressed that earlier in the show. We don't need to go back over that. Do you think this case will still go to trial? You know, I've always said no. At this point, I mean, I'm more yes than I was. Like, I'm 50-50 at this point. I know. I should have a freestyle just on Jill Daniels. It's true. What's going to happen at the Andrew Johnson hearing? I have no idea. Who gives a shit if she has a job? They like to go after jobs, so we do the same. Cancel culture works both ways, son. Colin called Beatty's daughter at 12:33. Colin's lawyer is Joe Krowski. Higgins flipping? Probably. I think that's pretty implied by now. And we will play that audio. We will break down and analyze the shit out of that Jill Daniels call. She didn't say that Jen called, so no, we will not. I don't think he's going to have many tackles this year. Where do you buy merch? It's in the Turtle Boy store. Go to the website. There's a tab up top for the store. What prompted the FBI to get involved? I have no idea, but common sense. I'm assuming that her attorneys went to them. I'm guessing that, but I could be wrong. Hearing the J.O.'s taillight embedded into his clothes. Sure he did. You're hearing that from who? Who are you hearing that from? Taillight embedded into his clothes. Yeah, sure he does. I've been meaning to write about the Rutland pedophile. I've just had my hands full. I know, dude. I need loser t-shirt. You're a loser. Loser. So many good t-shirts could come out of this. Oh, loser. What else could we, how dare they would be a good one. Stop. Oh, she wasn't, insinuating that. She was saying that, that Higgins flipped. Like, that's, I guess it's an insinuation, but she was clearly suggesting, like, if there were any confirmation about how they felt about Brian Higgins, we know it is now. We know what the FBI will charge with, because murder isn't a federal crime. I don't know. Good question. Any further on the how long to digest food? I mean, she did Google that. It's a weird thing to Google at 6:24, I think. I don't have much on that. We'll play. It's getting late. So, you know, we do have a great audience here. I really appreciate it. What we're going to re-listen to that whole thing. We're going to have some fun with it. We're just going to have to clip the whole Jill Daniels call. And we're going to have some fun with that. So thank you guys for joining me tonight. I really appreciate all the love. The donos appreciate that. One more from Joseph. He just sends $100. No comment, but he sends a hondo. So thank you. That's a high note to end on right there. So we will we'll call it a night, guys. And I thank you guys so much for the support, as always. And thank you guys for supporting Karen Reed as well. I'm sure she really appreciates it. And we're going to keep up we're going to keep this up. We're going to get justice for Karen and John, and keep on trucking. So, all right, people, peace, Turtle Riders.